Set to play their home games at Swangard Stadium in Burnaby. I'm Howard Smurry, your play-by-play announcer, joined as always by our analyst Nick Sersky. As the Simon Fraser clan be introduced to the fans here at Swangard, they will today take on the South Dakota School of Mines Hardrockers. Some interesting results over the first couple of weeks of this season, Nick. Big losses against exceptional opponents on the road, but they come home today. And there's been some adversity, especially at the quarterback spot here with the Simon Fraser team.
Yeah, the loss to Siebert is going to be way heavily on this season. We've told he's going to be out for the year. But you know what? That's going to give a lot of young guys a lot of opportunity. They've got 8 freshman starters, half on offense, half on defense, but also 8 seniors on this team. So a little mix of young and old, and we're taking on a South Dakota School of Mines team that lost a few key players this offseason, and so they're pretty young as well. So I think we're going to be in for a real battle here tonight.
And we'll get to those key losses for South Dakota in a second. You had a chance to watch a bit of Brandon Nixich, the freshman quarterback out of Todd Beamer High School in Federal Way, Washington. A big arm, and now getting his second straight start.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see. You know, he's kind of thrown in the fire last week, a couple reps in the first week of practice, and then, you know, now he's the starter and he's the guy. He's got a bit of a cannon. We'll see how accurate that cannon is, but if the O-line can protect him, we've got a good left side there, a couple seniors in Tangay and Bailey Elder,
Tyler Wood,
the senior, and so it's going to be interesting to see what he can do back there, and if this run game can get some tread, it'll help out Nixich a lot.
The run game is interesting. Just talk about that as to how the offensive line has been playing. Solomon Hines, a real speed burner, a guy who is on the track team here at SFU, is going to be their starting running back, but it's been tough to get anything here on the ground.
Totally. He's fast, but he's got net yards of 49 on the season, so on 22 rushes. So we'll take us down to the anthems here as we are close to getting underway.
Thank you.
kickoff here from Swangard Stadium in Burnaby. Howard Smura, along with Nick Sersky, our analyst, and Nick, as we prepare for the start of Simon Fraser and South Dakota Mines. Pretty hard to miss number 19 on that Clan team. Rice and John had over 100 yards receiving against Portland State, a Division I team, but got the blanket coverage at Angelo State in Texas. What's big about Rice and John other than his height, and how important is he going to be tonight?
Well, and look for him to be the number one target for a young Nick Sitch here tonight, because Rising can do it all. He can go over the middle. He can beat you deep. And he can be a good possession receiver as well. So he's a pretty exciting senior here, and one of the captains that's going to trot out to midfield shortly. Offensively for Nick Sitch, you've got to keep it simple, because if you're going to get too complicated, and I know that Coach Holland, offensive coordinator, is going to keep that in mind when he's doing the play calling here today. We've got a young quarterback, we've got a young backfield, but a very experienced offensive line. So I think if they can keep Nick Sitch upright and just give him a couple short reads, easy reads to get himself going. That'll be what the Clan need here in this first quarter to get this thing going.
He's number 17. You see him on the sidelines right now warming up. Brandon Nixitch, it'll be interesting to watch the freshman at work here today. Great last week, although it was a lopsided loss to Angelo State, that Ethan Basalt stepped up when Rising John was covered and had over 100 yards.
Exactly, and he can be their underneath sort of possession receiver. He's a smaller frame, but can catch and run after the catch as well. Exciting offensive talent position that we have here, and we were talking with Coach Ford earlier in the week, and he said that the wide receiver position is the deepest that they have. And we can talk about a new addition, but an old addition. 2 years since we've seen our friend Gavin Cobb coming back, missed all of last year with a hamstring injury, and making his first appearance for the Clan here this evening. So excited to see what he's got. Of course, his return skills were second to none 2 years ago, second in the NCAA Division II in terms of yardage. So I'm excited to see how they employ him here tonight, whether he's going to be strictly a returner or whether he's going to take over his outside receiver position as well. So interesting to see how this offense sort of gels as this season moves along. It's going to be an exciting game.
Gavin Cobb, as Nick mentioned, not on the two deep here. For special teams or, you know, as part of that offense. But, yeah, you're right, number two in punt return yardage in NCAA Division II football. We see him on the field right now wearing number 11, the terrific star to Mount Douglas Secondary School in Victoria. As well, we should mention, Christy Elliott, the kicker, on the verge of some potential history here. Let us know what's happening there.
Yeah, pretty interesting. We've seen the piece that you did at Hunter earlier in the season, and we've been told that if and when SFU scores a touchdown, that she'll kick the extra point. And if she does make it, she'll be the first female in Canadian history to score in a university football game. So very exciting, and a little piece of history here we could have tonight.
Wow, and she will be wearing number 88, and the ball just explodes off her foot. And the extra point, she's been so automatic every time I've seen her practicing with the team. So that will be exciting to see if that can happen for a very special player at Windsor Secondary in North Vancouver. Christy Elliott wearing number 88 in red today. These new Clan jerseys as well, Nick, as we get set for the kickoff.
Here. Yeah, fresh looks. This nice new helmets down there look a little bit like Ole Miss down there, but looks really good. And excited to get a new season with you underway, Howie. Excited to see where this young team goes this season, and hopefully we can stay healthy other than our friend Justin Sieber.
And you know what? It's interesting. This South Dakota Mines team has following a very similar script. They lost a ton of huge offensive talent last year, and we'll get to them over the course of this game. But they're a young team, too. They're young at quarterback, young at running back, everywhere.
Yeah, probably most importantly, last week they lost their starting quarterback, Spencer Zur, the sophomore, and they're going to be going with Toby Smith, who's attempted two passes on the season, both in completion. So we're going to see what the Hardrockers have in terms of depth as well, just as we are going to be seeing with the Clan.
Well, Simon Fraser getting ready. They will receive the opening kick. Looks like Riley Morrison, one of the return guys, set up back there. Nick, can you grab another number for me there?
I think it's 83, Aiden Pierce as well, from North Van, the sophomore.
So Pierce and Morrison back to return the opening kickoff here. As we get set, the game clock now showing 15 minutes, the first quarter set to begin. Simon Fraser back at Swangard Stadium. And it'll be Pierce with the football, crossing the 20, and might have made his way up to about the 25-yard line. And that's where Brandon Nixich will lead the Clan here for the first time this season at home. Interesting to remember Simon Fraser, their last win against the Division II program in the GNAC came right here at Swangard Stadium. 2014 was the year, and Jacques Chapdelaine in his 1 year as the Clan head coach was the man in charge. A real high scoring 53-31 win for Simon Fraser that game. Cobb in motion, he's gonna take the pass on a reverse, and not a lot of yards there. Might have gained two or three, but Gavin Cobb not listed on the two deep. He's the first guy to touch the ball.
And it's interesting. We chatted about it pregame. He gets the ball the first touch of the game. So interested to see, you know, where his fitness is at after sitting out the first two games. But he's definitely a speed demon, but also can catch the deep ball. So excited to see how the SFU is going to implement him.
Rising John wide to the near side of the field. Cobb lining up in the slot out of the shotgun with Hines in the backfield. Solomon will take the handoff, finding his way up the middle, and some positive yardage there for that Simon Fraser running back, Solomon Hines. Good to see the push, too, early in this game.
We saw a lot of that last year as well, just sort of the single back pistol or offset sort of look, and just a zone run up the middle. Gets a good push, gain of 4 yards, making it a manageable, which is what you want for a freshman quarterback, manageable third and four opportunity here for Simon Fraser.
Let's see if Nixich will go to the air here, wearing number 17, a pure freshman pushed into action following the injury to the sophomore Justin Siebert. A handoff again. This time KC Kircher, and it looks like he got enough, Nick, for that first down.
It's going to be close, Howie. And they are moving the sticks.
So Simon Fraser, three snaps, and they get a first down. And the hometown fans loving that. KC Kircher, you're going to see him number 45, as well as Solomon Hines, number 9, making up the majority of those snaps out of the offensive backfield. Nixich again, this time stepping back to pass. Has a man, it's Cobb. Great move by Gavin, and he's got a first down and more. Out past midfield, welcome back, Gavin Cobb.
Yeah, just nice little trips bunch to the far side, and Cobb just sort of sat down in a soft zone there. We'll see it on the replay here. Nixich sits back and fires to Cobb, one of his favorite targets here early on in this game.
Cobb now lining up to the near side of the field. First and 10 for the Simon Fraser Clan at the 48-yard line of the Hardrockers. Here's Nixich, looks to the far side of the field, has a man. Cobb again, and might have gained a yard. But they're certainly not shy of using the multifaceted skills of Gavin Cobb.
Well, and I think we're going to see a lot of this, Howie, is that four wide, four receivers. As we talked to Ford, he did mention that the receivers are probably their most deep position. So makes sense that they're going to line up four wide and let Nixich sling it.
Steven Alasco with a nice tackle there for South Dakota. Second and 9 here. Trips to the near side of the field. The handoff is to Hines. He's going to the far side of the field, and he is going to bull his way to a first down. A great job by Solomon Hines.
Yeah, and just that left side really collapsed down, and Solomon was able to get about a 9-yard gain there. That's number 78 for Simon Fraser. Bailey Elder, the left tackle, really giving a good push on that left side,
highly
and gives him a first down.
That's right. Sorry, Nick. Highly touted Bailey Elder. Playing like an experienced vet here in the GNAC. He's a pure freshman, but probably the highest recruited, I think a 3-star recruit, and the first one that Simon Fraser has brought into the program in the NCAA era. Great cut as he plants, but Solomon Hines is going to feel some push. The ball squirts loose, and it's picked up by South Dakota. Number 15, Will Carroll, in there to grab that football.
I think they're going to call forward progress. It stopped, Howie. I see the far official coming in and blowing it dead, so... Boy, that was close.
Simon Fraser catching a break there, and it's a nice, easy reminder about ball protection when you can dodge the bullet here on second and 9. The 37-yard line, and here they go. Nixich eludes some initial pressure, scrambles to the far side, goes to the sidelines, and has a man. That's number 13, Ryan Naylor, making a nice catch.
Boy, and he actually had Rising John over the middle, deep post, but really good job. We see it on the replay here. Nixich able to elude that pressure. Not really known for his fleet of foot, but able to bounce around back there and create something out of nothing.
Yeah, avoids a big loss and squares his shoulders on the pass. Still a third and long here for Simon Fraser. Nixich steps up into the pressure, but he is going to get taken down and he's going to feel that one.
Yeah, Nixitz looked to the right. We'll see here the pressure really from everywhere from the Rockers from that left side. That's number 38. You mentioned Howie Thomas Chapman beating the right tackle there, Nick Giffen, and going to force a fourth down here. But, hey, that's really good strides here for Simon Fraser. A couple first downs and flipping the field position here. We'll see what Keyes Metzler, the punter, can do here, trying to pin South Dakota down inside the 10-yard line.
Metzler's had a great start to his season, and we'll see his placement skills here. As you talk about, he's going to drop that thing down. It's going to take a bounce to SFU to field it. Great job by Keyes Metzler. It looks like just outside the 5-yard line.
And a beautiful punt by Metzler, really putting South Dakota Mines in some negative field position, and that's what you want defensively for Simon Fraser.
Toby Smith, the quarterback for South Dakota, will come out. His top person out of the backfield is the freshman, Ahmad Lewis, number 9. As they replace some heavy losses in the backfield. Connor Silveria last year, just a beast for South Dakota. So Toby Smith, number 10. See what this Simon Fraser defense is all about here in the early going. They've got a great opportunity to make a statement here. The Hard Rockers deep in their own end. Here's, shedding a tackle and getting out over the 15-yard line. That was Ahmad Lewis. We just talked about him. He looked strong.
Looked really good on that play, and good blocking by that offensive line. They actually pulled the backside guard. They had offset and pulled the tackle over to the left side as well. So a good run there and a quick first down for School of Mines.
Well, I like the strength he brings to it. Look at this. He's going through some bodies, and he's going to be a workhorse. You can tell already Ahmad Lewis is going to be relied on a lot here today.
Well, and similar to Simon Fraser, when you have a young quarterback who hasn't seen too many snaps here in Division II football, you want that run game to be able to relieve some pressure for that Toby Smith.
So here's Smith on second down, this time in the air, and a catch made just over the 30-yard line for the first down. Anthony Ulrich, one of the younger receivers in that deep core of receivers.
Smith looks poised back there, really just steps his first read. Was number 11 there, and Anthony Ulrich, good completion, nice pitch and catch, easy first down for the Rockers.
So here come the Hard Rockers as they make their way deep out of their own end, now at the 31-yard line. Smith this time to the near sideline, number 19, the turnaround, almost made a great catch, but some great defensive coverage there from the pure freshman out of Notre Dame Secondary School, Jarrell Cummings.
Yeah, and he had single coverage there, man-to-man, and he just took a shot. Smith did, and great coverage there. Was able to rip that ball away as he's falling down, number 8 Cummings.
And not an easy job for a kid straight out of high school. So Jarrell Cummings doing a nice job there. That was Colin Zur, the target. So now second and 10 here. And Lewis will be met immediately.
It's big number 59 in the middle there. Thomas Jackson.
Nice stop by the Clan.
Beats his blocker there and rips him down for no gain.
So a big third down here for the Hard Rockers. Simon Fraser wanting desperately to make a defensive statement here early in this game.
We'll see. Do they want to bring some heat on the freshman quarterback? Are they going to sit back and let him pick him apart? Let's see.
Well, Smith's got some time. He steps out of the pocket now and wants to sling it downfield. Oh, I think that hit the ground. Are they going to call that a catch? I think that was no catch. They were looking for Anthony Ulrich again, number 11.
Great job by Smith to really reset his feet and, you know, get it about 40 yards downfield. And sort of in between two receivers, falls incomplete, brings up fourth down for the Hard Rockers.
I really thought Simon Fraser would be able to backpedal and perhaps get a pick there, Nick. But you're right, it fell in some no man's land. Luckily for the Hard Rockers, who will now punt away the football. Simon Fraser with a chance here to really set the table. And guess who's lined up to return this punt? It looks like it's going to be Gavin Cobb. Ooh, they bobble the snap. They get the kick away, but it is not a good kick. And it's going to take a South Dakota bounce, though, and go out about the 36-yard line of the Clan.
Yeah, we've got a wet field down there, Howie. It hasn't rained recently, but this morning there was some rain in the area, so that ball might be a little slick. And we saw that that long snap just to give the punter a little bit of a slippery ball there and shanked off the side of his foot. So giving Simon Fraser some plus field position there. We'll see what Nixitch can do.
Nixitch at his 40. If you're wondering why we're at Swangard, Simon Fraser is getting a brand new stadium. We hope we'll be there 1 year from now, Nick, calling the games from the new stadium atop Burnaby Mountain. But Swangard Stadium will be a cozy home here in 2019. There is Solomon Hines, plants a foot, tries to find a crease and can't. He's met by a host of Hardrocker tacklers.
Really bunched up that middle there, Howie. Not much for the running back there. And you see four or five Hardrockers pulling him back. But, second and eight, at least we didn't take a loss. And Nixitch can survey his options here. Trips to the far side again. We saw Cobb get open in this formation earlier.
And here's Cobb in motion. Nixitch throws to the sideline, just throwing it away there. Taking the high percentage play.
I think they were looking for Cobb in the flat here, but too much pressure there by number 42. That's Chaddock for the Hardrockers, and Nixitch does a smart thing, just throws it away.
So third and long here, a big play on this drive for Simon Fraser. They'd certainly love to build some momentum here. But that Hardrocker pass rush making its presence felt. Nixitch steps up in the pocket. He is going to face the pressure, and he's going to go down. And Brandon Nixitch is having a bit of a rough time right back there right now. You got to be impressed with his pass rush.
Yeah, and just not much down the field, Howie. The Hardrockers really covered it up. Only rushed three, and then a bit of a delay blitz there by number seven, DeChochia. And was able to force Nixitch up in the pocket and a sack and a three and out here for Simon Fraser.
Thomas Chapman there again, number 38. He's making his presence felt for South Dakota in the early going. So that's going to be Anthony Ulrich back to return this punt.
Ooh, and it's tipped.
Yeah, it doesn't really take a Simon Fraser bounce as well. They'll field it right at midfield. We'd love to get another look at that one. We'll see that here on our Clan TV replay.
Yeah, just a little bit of pressure up the middle and got tipped by the pressure coming over top of the upbacks. And now the Hardrockers have some plus field position here. We'll see what Toby Smith can do.
They have run it with their freshman running back, Ahmad Lewis, but they've also put the ball in the air in the early going, finding receivers like Ulrich. So we'll see how things go here for the redshirt sophomore quarterback. The handoff now to Lewis. He's elusive, and he gets a real quick burst for about a 4.5 yard gain up the middle.
Yep, just sort of crashed down to the right there, and he cuts back. Nice stick there by Brendan Lowry coming off from his defensive back position to limit that gain.
Well, Lowry leading the team out of that secondary anyway, tackle-wise, has had a great start to his season. Smith this time finding Lewis out of the backfield, and here he goes, first down and more, down to the 20, the 15, the 10. He's going to get taken down by Lowry, but inside the 10-yard line. A huge play as the running back comes out of the backfield and makes it count.
Just sort of a flip out to the flats here, and just some over pursuit by the Simon Fraser tacklers, and we just see the speed of Ahmad Lewis there, the freshman from Tacoma, Washington. Coach Tom Ford's backyard there, and brings it down inside the 10, first and goal.
Yeah, he's elusive, but he's powerful as well, and it's a great combination here for the Hardrockers, who are knocking on the door. Lewis bounces off the front. This time will be held to a smaller gain down to about the 10-yard line.
We'll see it here on the replay. Just great penetration from Simon Fraser. It's number 59 getting in the backfield and really causing havoc. Thomas Jackson again making his presence known in the middle.
Thomas Jackson impressive early, but the Clan with some work to do here to keep the Hardrockers off the board on second down. Little play fake, and they go to Ulrich, and he's going to get taken down. A great open field tackle there to save a touchdown. I believe that was Dawson Marchant in on the stop. We'll take a look on the replay here.
Yeah, and that's a great tackle. It goes low and clips the heels.
Lowry, actually.
Of the Hard Rocker defender, creating third down here. And this would be a big stop for Simon Fraser after allowing that big play to Lewis earlier.
Third and three. As Smith out of the shotgun looking downfield. He's going to do a little flip and right to the tight end. And they're going to go in for the score. And that's Ira Murphy, I believe.
Yeah, just a nice little shovel pass on the inside here. You pull the tackle, and you have to make that defensive end choose which way to go. And he took the quarterback, so you flip it inside to the tight end. Really an easy play for that quarterback as well, because if it's not there, he's just going to throw it in the dirt. It was, and that's a touchdown for the Hard Rockers. They're going to take an early 6-0 lead.
So the tight end from South Dakota, he's an in-state product from Rapid City. Ira Murphy scoring the touchdown there, 6-0 for the Hard Rockers. And Nick, that play, though, out of the backfield to the running back, Ahmad Lewis, a big one. It really sets them up well.
And it didn't really look like there was much there, but some over-pursuit from Simon Fraser's tacklers, and Ahmad was able to cut it back inside and took it about 50 yards down into the red zone. And really, the play of the game so far, bringing the Hard Rockers into scoring range, and they convert.
Reminds me of Penny with the Seahawks. I mean, he's a bigger guy at this GNAC level anyway, a real guy who can run with some power. Simon Fraser player being helped off the field is James Pack, a starter on that defensive line, so let's hope he's okay.
Yeah, he's their nose tackle in that 3-4 scheme. It'd be a big loss for him, the senior. If he's not able to come back, we'll check on him later in the game.
Enos Sifa on to attempt the extra point. And that will go through for a 7-0 lead. So the Hard Rockers coming in here 0-2 on the season. Get off to a good start here in the first quarter. 4:36 remaining. Howard Smura, Nick Sirski here from Swangard Stadium. What's your initial thought on Niksic? You know what? He was a guy who may well have redshirted this season, right? You never know what their plans were, but thrust into duty and really having to learn on the fly.
And looks relatively poised back there, but has been pressured on a few dropbacks and has sort of disrupted his rhythm. He's made some nice throws, and on the day he's 3-for-4, but he's been pressured a lot. A couple sacks for the Hard Rockers on these Simon Fraser drives. So look for Simon Fraser to continue doing what they want to do. They're going to spread, three or four receivers out wide and see if that zone read scheme can work for Niksic. If not, he's going to pull it and try and find Cobb or Ryzen John down the field. Cobb's been a favorite target here early in this game.
Riley Morris at number 6, Aiden Pierce, 83, back to return the kickoff. Well, Pierce is going to take it out across his 10, but he's going to get hit immediately and taken down at about the 11-yard line.
An interesting choice to return that one. I bet you his special teams coach is
he thought about it.
Going to tell him to take a knee next time and get it out to the 25. But
great job downfield there by on special teams by Gavin Chaddock, number 42, who came flying in there to make the tackle.
We see Simon Fraser again trot out those four wide receivers, even deep in their own zone.
Hines in the backfield. Simon Fraser deep in their own end here, wanting to make something happen. It's a handoff to Hines, and they'll try and push up to about the 15-yard line.
A little sweep motion by Cobb coming across to the left. You'll see it here, and then they pull that guard and tackle to try and create a little bit more of an opening for Solomon Hines. Gets a decent gain there, 5-6 yards. You always like that on first down.
Dynamic. Cobb and Ryzen John lined up next to each other here on the near side of the field. Number 4, Ethan Basalt also out there. Hines, tough going there in the tackle by number 59, Brockemeyer, Justin Brockemeyer, the junior.
Yeah, just not much there. We see just a simple zone run scheme, but Brockemeyer able to penetrate his gap and bring Hines down for about a 2 or 3 yard gain. bringing up a third and short here for Simon Fraser deep in their own end. This would be a great conversion if they could get it.
Looking downfield, Nixitch, quick release. But I don't think they got it here as they are driven back immediately.
Looks like he did. They'll give him the spot here, Howie. They found success with that trips bunch to the wide side.
And great job, you're right.
This time it was John sitting down in that middle zone there, and that's Nick Sitch's first read. If he sees it's open, gain of 5 yards and a first down.
So number 13, Ryan Naylor making the catch there. A first down for Simon Fraser.
Oh, pardon me, Naylor.
Yeah, number 13, I think, was the guy that made the catch there. This time, though, it is indeed Ryzen John, his first touch of the game, and John making the catch but getting driven back after a bit of a gain.
And I think we're going to see a lot of this, just some short passes to get Nick Sitch comfortable in his rhythm, and if John can break that, then they'll, there'll be a big play. If not, it's a nice four-yard gain on first down to make it second and manageable.
Second down here now for Simon Fraser. Near side of the field, putting it up. That's right there for Gavin Cobb. He has the speed. Gavin Cobb, the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Simon Fraser.
What a play from Gavin Cobb. Just runs a wheel route down the right side, and Nixitch puts it on him perfectly. There were flags at the end of the play, probably for the celebration backing up into the end zone. But
take a look at it here in our Clan TV replay. Nice touch from the freshman quarterback right in the bucket to Gavin Cobb, who makes a great catch, and they are not going to catch him now.
What a play down the sideline. I think he watched the referee throw the flag out of his pocket there. You see it on the replay.
Welcome back, Gavin Cobb. Hurt in training camp as Thomas Ford took over this team last season. And the season before, Nick, we mentioned it right on the pregame, number 2 in punt return yardage in all of D2 football. Here the kid is from Mount Douglas, and he hasn't lost a step.
So, and actually, Howie, that's a big penalty, because in NCAA football, for a celebration penalty, it looks like they're taking the touchdown off the board.
They are.
And now it will be a 15-yard penalty from the goal line. So Simon Fraser will take a penalty. And we'll see it on the... They called a celebration unsportsmanlike conduct penalty on Simon Fraser, which takes the score off the board.
Well, I have never seen that, but is it because he turns before he crosses the goal line, perhaps?
Not sure, but
we'll take a look at this.
What a nice throw from Nixitch. But, yeah, I'm not sure the ruling in the college game, Howie, but obviously that's not what you want from Gavin Cobb in his first game back, and Coach Tom Ford's not going to be excited about that play.
Well, take that one off the board. I'll wipe my excitement away and say it's now tinged with disappointment. What a huge turn of events here. So Simon Fraser, it looks to me like if you try to project where it was that he turned around, perhaps it's
I'd love to have a chat with a GNAC official and see what the official ruling is on that.
Oh, this time a incompletion.
But it will indeed take the score off the board. So Simon Fraser's going to have to recoup here. They took a timeout. Coach Tom Ford probably smartly just wants his guys to reset. Obviously not a smart decision by Cobb to get that penalty. But Simon Fraser still down deep in the red zone here, looking to convert.
Yeah, incomplete to Naylor. We'll talk about that touchdown more. Here's Solomon Hines trying to take it wide. Wants a straight arm. Is he going to get the edge? They all bail on the flag crew as he can't get around the edge, and here they are now facing third and long. Wow.
And just not much push there from that left side. It was 38 again. Thomas Chapman, we've been saying his name a lot this afternoon, or this evening, pardon me. Getting some penetration and pushing Hines out to the left, and a loss of one on the play.
Well, completely turning your body around is a no-no. I guess you can look over your shoulder, but you can't turn around and backpedal. Here's Nixitch, and he's just going to throw that one away. So the Klan will
Boy, what a turn of events here, Howie. From a very exciting play to now a fourth down here for Simon Fraser. It looks like the field goal kicker is going to come in. And that's, of course, David Eisenkraft, the freshman, 0-for-2 on the season. This is about a 35-yard field goal. Both field goals he's attempted were in the 40-yard range. One was blocked earlier in the season. Here's a 35-yarder.
They sure want to get something out of this. And that is good. Oh, it's not.
Just wide to
Just
the right.
Just wide. Nick.
That's a big call.
Oh.
That's a big call. And unfortunately for Simon Fraser, it doesn't go their way. And now a missed field goal. It gives them no points on the drive instead of tying this one up. But for Simon Fraser, now you just have to reset. You saw some good things offensively for the Klan, and just got to continue doing that. Nixitch and Cobb, don't get your heads down. Just going to have to regroup offensively. They moved the ball well on that drive. And now defensively, don't allow the big play. Keep South Dakota pinned down in their own end here and take the ball over at half if you can. South Dakota takes a timeout here with 1:27 left in the half. Boy, what a change of events, Howie. Really awesome to be back here at Swangard Stadium. Good crowd here on hand. We see some shirtless men down there in the front row dancing. I'm sure they've got something painted on their chest here. Really good atmosphere here at Simon Fraser, cheering on the Klan.
Well, renewed interest to a greater level here for the Klan. You're right about that, Nick. I'm just still trying to get the win back in the sails after Gavin Cobb had that beautiful touchdown taken off the board.
And just like Simon Fraser, we're going to have to move on, Howie.
Wow, we're going to have to move on, I guess. I just.
And you have to. And that's a big play in the game. But look, it's still only 7-0, and Simon Fraser's here primed to.
Can I ask you, have you ever seen that happen before?
I've never seen it happen.
I've never seen that.
I'd love to see the ruling on that. I'm not sure if it did happen in the end zone, would the score have counted? It did. They did mark off 15 yards from the 2, which was where Gavin turned around. I'm actually not sure on that ruling, and that's our ignorance up here.
We've got some veteran people here in the stat crew who have still, they also have never seen it. And I am just, wow, that is amazing.
Smith rolls out to his right. We got flags on the play here. We'll see what the call is. But hey, you learn something every day, right?
You do. Don't want to learn it that way. So now a penalty against Dawson Marchant in that defensive secondary, number one from the Klan. Must have been a late hit or something. Smith was going to the far sideline, Nick.
I think they called it defensive holding down the field, so 10-yard penalty and a first down.
And here's a handoff, some open field and some tough running, courtesy of number 33, Caleb Roth, the freshman. So a nice 1-2 punch from the first-year running backs. Lewis and Roth. Look at Roth.
Yeah, big
dragging.
Gap. Big gap up the middle. He's able to pick up 17 yards on that play.
Brendan Lowry doing his best to drag him down, but they get up to about the 48-yard line, and it's a first down. This time Roth again, elusive as he lowers those pads, Nick, and gets a gain of about 6 yards.
Yeah, they're really churning this ground game, Howie. The offensive line, kudos to them getting a good push here against Simon Fraser. James Pack, don't believe I've seen him back in the game yet, which would be a big loss for this defensive line.
Starting nose tackle, as you mentioned. This time a handoff, and a play fake, and they're going to go to the far sideline. They have a man open for the first down. And once again, Anthony Ulrich with a nice catch on that far sideline.
And that's what a successful run game can do, Howie.
I was just going to say. You
pull the chute, and you roll your quarterback out to the right, give him an easy flip out to the flat, pick up a first down.
Yeah, nice run-pass balance here for these young Hard Rockers. Of course, you saw that little shovel pass to the tight end for the touchdown earlier in the game. And that'll do it for the first quarter of play here. 7-0, the Hard Rockers on top. We'll take a short break here from Swangard Stadium and be back with more in a moment. And welcome back, everybody, to Swangard Stadium. Howard Smura, Nick Sirski. Here, the home opener at Swangard Stadium, the South Dakota Hardrockers with a 7-0 lead, and some numbers from that opening quarter.
And Nixich looking good, 6 for 9 in the first quarter. Gavin Cobb, obviously his favorite target, 3 catches for 89 yards and a long of 73, but of course the big penalty that brought that one back. Not super successful on the ground so far tonight, but Simon Fraser still in this game here, just down 7 after the first.
They got to keep their wits about them after the Cobb TD was taken off the board and they missed that field goal. Klan 0 for 3 now on field goal attempts this season. Another run up the middle. I think that was Roth. I didn't quite get the number.
Yep, Roth again up the middle to the right. We just see a good push here from South Dakota. Creates a nice gap and Roth is able to rumble forward for, carries a couple tacklers for 6 yards and creates a second to manageable for a freshman quarterback.
Yeah, Jack Baffle the fourth and Grant Smith 73 and 75 at the front of that offensive line getting major traction. So a big gain there on first down, sets up about a second and 5. Is Roth again. And they are just humming down the middle of the field here.
Yeah, and with a freshman quarterback, that's what you want to do. Now they're going to come up to the line, run a bit of no huddle. We'll see it on the replay here. Just dragging Simon Fraser tacklers down the field, picking up a first down, coming down just outside the 20-yard line now.
All right, Nick. Tempo now in play here for the Hard Rockers. They'll hand off again. Great play,
nice play
in the backfield. 59 and 49, but the initial contact there from Brendan, or rather from Thomas Jackson, as well Isaac Muckey and the starting linebacker also in there.
Yeah, just a great play, slicing in from his, from the defensive right side and stopping that play in the backfield. That's a big play, as you know, the Rockers have really had success on first down.
So second and long now, I'll call it about second and 13. Smith right down the middle, a short little game there. Simon Fraser doing a good job there. And that pass going to Lubers, rather Colin Zur, I believe it was, number 19.
And that's their number one target. We haven't heard his name a lot tonight. He wasn't really open on the play, but Smith able to force that one in there to Zur. Getting back about 5-6 yards, creating a more third manageable situation here for Smith.
Yeah, so call it third and long. Big chance here for the Klan defense to hold them to just a field goal. No flag thrown there. Turn around and oh, a great opportunity for the first down inside the 10-yard line.
Boy, I thought someone jumped there, Howie, but no flags.
I was waiting for the laundry there. Nothing happened.
And Smith takes a shot down to Zur, his favorite target. Falls incomplete. So bring up fourth down.
So that,
see the kicker.
Some bend but don't break there.
And SF is 2 for 3 on the season with a long of 42, so this is well inside his range. But a 38-yard field goal.
Snap down, the kick is up. And it's good. So a 10-0 lead here now for the Hard Rockers. 12:47 to the break.
Some pressure there, but SF able to knock that through pretty confidently.
Now you're right, Nick. They are setting up their freshman quarterback for success with a nice run game. They're not getting adventurous in the pass game. They're taking what's there, and they're not squandering opportunities, and they're leading 10-0.
Exactly, and that's what you have to do for a young quarterback. That run game is going to be very important. We'll see what Simon Fraser can do on their now fourth drive here on the or in this game. Be nice to get Hines a little bit more openings. We've had a couple, you know, 4 or 5 yard gains, but if he could bust a big one, I think that'd be good for the Simon Fraser offensive line confidence. That's a big group and a couple seniors on that team that have been here a while, and getting a ground game going would be something that'd be very pivotal for Nixich and the key to this offense.
Certainly, Simon Fraser wanting to find that balance, and they did that all of last year too, wanting to get that run-pass balance in some kind of semblance, but have not been able to do it. They may just start leaning on their passing game, filled with weapons. We'll see what happens here as they get set to kick off to Pierce and Morrison. It's going to go to Pierce at his own 10 to the 20. Nice return out to almost the 30-yard line there for Aiden Pierce.
Yep, good return for Simon Fraser. Just a little bit of a right return there. Breaks a couple tackles. Aiden Pierce and falls down around the 30, giving Nick Sitch some good field position to work with here for Simon Fraser.
He doesn't look like the prototypical...
No, he's a big kid.
Kickoff returner, but he seems to know what he's doing out there.
6'1", 180 pounds, but clearly Coach Ford trusts him back there and able to make a play on that one.
So Nick Sitch now waiting the snap on first down. Hines in the backfield. Solomon will take the handoff. Tough sledding again. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but not much more on first down.
And a late flag as well. It's going to be number 80. I think that's Phillips.
Christian Phillips needs to
push there after the play was over.
So the Clan need to help themselves here. They'd be right in this football game with that touchdown. That is a backbreaker and now a penalty here.
Here's the call on sportsmanlike conduct. Number 80.
So the tight end.
That's a big penalty. That's 15 yards from the end of the run, so it's going to be second and 24.
Yeah, this is shoot yourself in the foot territory, really, for Simon Fraser. Christian Phillips getting called for the penalty there. So second and forever here, second and 25 for the Clan.
We'll see what Coach Holland does here. Does he take a shot or just try and get half of it back?
They're going to take their shot down the field to Rice and John. Oh, and he got his hands on it. Couldn't squeeze it, and the coverage was there for number 24, and that was Chandler Calejo.
Yeah, it just looked like a cover three scheme there, and John sort of running down the seam, a bit of a corner route, maybe fading to the corner, but just falls incomplete. Nice throw there by Nixich.
And he is putting a nice touch on these passes. A very catchable ball there for Rice and John. Just like it was for Gavin Cobb. Now they're going back to Cobb. And he's not going to get much here on third down.
Well, and just a couple penalties. The name of the game so far here, 3 minutes into the second quarter here, how one takes the score off the board and one puts Simon Fraser in really negative field position. So going to be key here for Simon Fraser after this punt. Obviously get a good punt away. We have seen one tipped, creating a short field for the Rockers. But if Metzler can get away a clean kick here and hopefully for the defense to force a three and out and try and get this ball back for Nixich with some time left in the second.
Keys Metzler averaging around 45 yards a punt here, so he's been very good. This time a low kick. It's going to come down about midfield. Oh, and a slip of a couple of tackles down to the sideline and a great return. And that is, as well, Anthony Ulrich doing it all here for this Hard Rockers team.
Boy, I thought I saw a bit of a block in the back there from number 25 to let them get that edge. But not called there. And South Dakota going to get some good field position here.
Well, this Clan defense on the field a lot here over the last couple series. They are having to keep their wits about them, as we said. They're having to defend in tough positions on the field. And if you're South Dakota, maybe you want to take a shot here, but they have certainly found their consistency through the ground game. This time Smith is going down. A nice ball down the field. And was there a push there? No.
Wow. Well,
no flag thrown there.
But a flag in the backfield, actually, Howie. Maybe they deem that uncatchable. Sure looked like he gave him a grab there. Holding's going to bring it back anyway. Coach Ford nodding in agreement down there.
Well, that was number 24, Peyton Reed, a cornerback from Inglemore High School, just south of the line, freshman.
Targeting Zur up there on the down the left side, and you mentioned it, Howie. Take a shot there on first down. Might as well give it a try. But now first and 20 for Simon Fraser, what they really want here defensively.
Ooh. Flags go. I think this is a free play down the field. A great job there. Simon Fraser. We'll have to see what happens. That was Dawson Marchant.
We'll see who jumped Howie, but usually if it's the offense, they're going to call it dead. But, boy, way to get up, pick that ball off.
Former Lord Tweedsmuir Panther out in Surrey, Dawson Marchant, has had a long journey since leaving high school, but here he is with the Clan.
It is indeed offside. Smart play by the freshman quarterback there. You know, when you do see that defensive line jump, take a shot downfield. You never know what can happen. Now, the turnover is not going to count, obviously, for Simon Fraser. And now first and 15 here for the Hardrockers.
So the freshman quarterback, Toby Smith, showing the penchant to put some nice touch on the ball as well, even with that nice running game the team has shown here. Here they go to the freshman, Ahmad Lewis. And he does his best to...
I think that was Anthony Crescenzo slicing in from the right, limit that gain as best possible.
Crescenzo, another freshman for that Simon Fraser defense. I believe that a sack... in the Angelo State game.
Put 3 yards on that play, second and 12. Again, four wide for the Hardrockers.
Oh, and they find Ulrich on the sideline down to the 30-yard line, and that is a catch. They're going to mark it at the 31.
Nice catch there by Ulrich. A nice throw by Smith. He takes his three-step drop and slings it over double coverage.
Ulrich is a redshirt sophomore, 5'10", 185 out of San Diego, California. And a nice grab there. First and 10, the 30-yard line. Ooh, bit of a rough handoff there, but Lewis is gonna gain a couple.
Yeah, you see Simon Fraser starting to creep a little bit more down into the box there as this ground game has giving them fits, but hopefully that doesn't open them up defensively in the secondary.
Second and 8 here now. Find a man. They had him wide open, and they couldn't squeeze it. Intended for Joe Lubers.
And Simon Fraser brought a blitz here. Coming through the middle. I think that was number 40, Isaac Evans. Slicing through the middle and just forced a bit of a not great throw there by Smith behind the receiver. Forcing another third down here and long.
Good job by Evans, the Terry Fox Raven, making his presence felt on that play. Clan defense doing a good job here, third and long.
And they'll take a timeout.
Take a timeout here, will the Hardrockers. 9:58 from the half.
Pivotal point here in the game, Howie. Want to force a field goal attempt here for the Hardrockers, going down by 17 or would not be preferred here in this game. But kudos to the Simon Fraser defensive unit here. They've sort of stuck with this defensive run pressure that they've been starting to blitz a little bit more, creating some heat and stopping the Hardrockers from any big plays on the ground. We saw some big runs earlier from Ahmad Lewis and hasn't been as effective on this drive.
You're right about that, and they were able to hold South Dakota to a field goal the last time they got deep. Certainly not preferred to be even limiting them to field goals, but they want to just manage the damage the best they can here and try and gain some offensive traction of their own. Here we go, third and 8. From the 29-yard line.
Single coverage on the short side here. No.
A lot of time for the quarterback. Oh, and right through the hand. Simon Fraser almost coming up with a pick there.
And that was well played there from Simon Fraser. That was number 16, Anthony Crescenzo, dropping from his outside linebacker spot underneath that. And just sort of confused Toby Smith a bit, forced him to roll to the left. I think they like that one-on-one matchup, but not able to get open. And now forcing a field goal attempt for the Hardrockers. This one a little bit longer than the last one from the 36-yard line, so a 46-yarder that would be his season long.
Simon Fraser would love to dodge the bullet here if they can. Snap and the kick. Oh, and it is...
no good.
Not even close. Simon Fraser, the defense does the job, Nick, and they've got to build on that momentum. See if the offense can't reward the defense for a great stand in holding the Hardrockers off the board.
Yep, and that's all you can ask for defensively when you're sort of setting some negative field position. Stop and get a field goal attempt. Fortunately, the kicker misses, and now Simon Fraser set up at the inside their own 30. But now we'll see what Nixich can do here. Just under 10 minutes left in the second quarter. He's been effective when he's had time. And I know that's sort of obvious for a quarterback, but if this offensive line can give him some time, I think that he can find some guys downfield and really start pushing the ball downfield like he wants to. I know he wants to. He's got a big arm.
That is Hines again in the backfield. This time a fake and a pass over the middle to the number five. I believe that was Adam. No, that's a defensive player. Am I missing
that
the number
six
there?
Morrison.
It was Morrison. Apologies.
Yep, just that zone read scheme that we see pretty often here. Nixich decides to pull it. Quick throw over the middle. Nice catch.
Great job. 9 yards on first down. Riley Morrison doing a good job. Of course, doubling on that kickoff return team as well for the Clan. Both he and Pierce to the near side of the field. Basalt's in motion. Nixich dodges the pressure. Throws on the run. Has a man. And that is a first down. A great job there as he finds Riley Morrison.
It was great recognition by Morrison. His route was actually taking him to the inside, but he saw his quarterback scrambling out to the left. He cuts his route back to the outside and completes a nice pass. Picks up a first down.
So the Clan move the chains, and the offense had been stalling. And nice to see from a Clan perspective. Nixich building some chemistry with the receiver Morrison. Hines this time up the middle for a gain of about 2 yards.
Just again, not much push there inside, just a little zone run. Pulled the tight end. Hines is swallowed up near the line of scrimmage, gets about a yard.
And there is big play potential in this Clan pass game for sure with both John and Cobb on the field. Nixich and company all of a sudden looking to the sideline.
Checking into something. He likes what he sees.
Oh, this one is not going anywhere. Blown up immediately on the handoff to Solomon Hines.
Just read well by the Hardrockers.
Number 92 for South Dakota getting in there to do some great work, and that's Darren Schreuer.
Nowhere to go. Now a third and long here for Simon Fraser. Really nice to convert this one around midfield.
We'll see if they can get a jump ball to Ryzen John. We haven't seen that really happen to any great extent in this game. Nixich now back, avoids the pressure, has to head back. He puts it up, and this time a completion, but well shy of the first down. Heading back to the ball, Ethan Basalt.
And good job by Nixich to avoid that pressure, but when he escapes about 10 yards back from his pocket, so any throw that he's going to make on the run there is not going to get to the sticks. Nice catch, nice connection. Way to avoid a negative play, but Simon Fraser is going to be forced to punt here just under 7 minutes left in the second quarter.
And this is where you start to see the maturity of the Simon Fraser team, and the defense doing a great job. Can they keep the mental tenacity going after the special teams kick here? And just keep battling for some field position to hand to their offense.
From midfield, should be able to get this one down inside the 10.
And Ulrich signals a fair catch at his own 10-yard line. We got some.
Great kick there by Metzlarda. Forced the Hardrockers to face a long field here. 6.5 minutes left. Simon Fraser did a great job stuffing that run in the last drive, forcing Toby Smith to throw a bit more than I think maybe the Hardrockers wanted him to. So we'll see what they can do now, pin deep in their own end. Hopefully Simon Fraser can force a three and out and get this ball back around midfield, give their offense another chance.
Maybe play into the hands of that Clan secondary, right? Dawson Marchand, Matt Duda, Brendan Lowry, Crescenzo. Be nice to see the Clan secondary make its mark here. This time a handoff. And it's Lewis again, this time a short gain.
And checking back there in the middle was James Pack, so good to see the senior back at that nose tackle position.
He was helped off the field. We should, if you missed that earlier in the game. So great to see him back on the field. Smith again faking the handoff. Rolling to the near side of the field, has a man, a completion. Right into that Simon Fraser sideline. We couldn't see who made the catch. Maybe we can on the replay here.
Pretty good coverage there by Duda. Closed fairly well, but just enough of a cushion there. I think that's Ulrich, 11.
And great pursuit in the backfield from Kieran Testa as well. This time they go to Ulrich again on first down, and he's going to gain a couple of yards. But you're right about that little screenplay there, but the running game has not been as effective.
Hey, you've seen Simon Fraser bring some more heat.
Oh, and a nice turn and catch there.
Wow, nice catch by Zur.
So Zur makes a nice catch and moves the sticks down the field for...
Now they fake the screen there, and you see Smith rolls to his left, and Zur kind of contorts his body coming back. Swinging around his right shoulder, making the catch. Nice play.
Yeah, Brendan Lowry on the coverage there as the Hard Rockers kind of reinventing themselves as a passing team now after really relying on that run to set up the pass early in this game. Here's Lewis up the middle. That's looking more vintage first quarter Hard Rockers runs up the middle.
That's what we've been used to here, Howie. Just, again, a little down block by the offensive line. Choose your hole, and... Lewis gets about 8 on the carry, and that's all you want on first down if you're a Hard Rocker fan.
Crescenzo there on the tackle. Second and short now. They're going to lean on this running game. And the freshman, and he will get a first down and more. Great job there again by Ahmad Lewis.
And that's what it can do, Howie. Just kind of tire down that defensive line. Gets about 15 yards on that carry. Nice inside run.
Yeah, Lowry again there. He's all over the ball in the field here, but first and 10, and the Hard Rockers on a march out there at the Simon Fraser 29-yard line. Lewis shedding tackles and still moving his feet, getting all the way down to the 20-yard line, just shy, I believe, of the first down.
We were actually chatting with Coach Ford earlier in the week. You were, Howie, and he mentioned how Lowry's their second leading tackler. He's like, we don't really want our safety to be the second leading tackler on our team. You want that to be your linebackers or your defensive end. So, boy, Simon Fraser's going to have to toughen
nice
up here
job
quick.
There, though, they may well have gotten the job done. Oh, they're saying they have the football, but we'll see what happens here.
I called them down there, Howie. See, was it out? Oh, wow, it was, Howie. It was out. But obviously no replay here in the...
Well, Monday Night Football, you know, that might
that
be Simon Fraser's football.
That
yeah.
would have been a challenge, but that definitely did come out before he was down. But great play there by Simon Fraser to punch that ball out. And well, now they're talking about it a bit, Howie.
Yeah, they are definitely talking about it, Nick, and you're right. When you look at that replay...
Oh, they're just talking about what down it is. Okay, third down here. Third down and one. You see Coach Ford giving it to the official. They're probably not happy that was called not a fumble. He has a good perspective there down right on the sideline. That happened about 10 yards from where he was.
A tough break for the Clan. Looking at the takeaway there would be pivotal at this point of the ball game. But instead, third and short, and they'll lower the pads and go with the battering ram, Caleb Roth.
So he just picked up enough to get it. And again, just that down blocks, and inside zone scheme picks up enough for the first down.
Well, it's been bend not break. The last couple of scoring plays, the Clan holding South Dakota off the board and limiting them to a field goal deep in the red zone, but this is getting to be a little too much to ask your defense, I think. There's Roth again, dragging tacklers down. A flag will fly.
Pull the tackle and the tight end. A little counter play. Create some room up the middle. I'm not sure what the flag was. Maybe a face mask that far downfield, but We'll see. The officials are talking about it. But, yeah, this is the vintage Hardrockers we've seen earlier in the first quarter, just really grinding that run game and creating some holes for Lewis and Roth and getting downfield and making those defensive back make tackles, which is not what you want.
If you're joining us late, Simon Fraser on a thrilling play had a touchdown taken off the board when the receiver Gavin Cobb turned around before he crossed the goal line in celebration. And Simon Fraser unable to, despite their good field position on that drive, to score.
They're picking up the flag. So it'll just be second down there, just outside the 10-yard line. Second and four. Be a really nice stop here for Simon Fraser if they could could force this.
If anything, well timed to get that Simon Fraser defense a bit of a rest here. A handoff again, and Roth just dragging tacklers down inside the 5-yard line. They got something special happening up front with that O-line, Nick.
Just getting out-muscled at the line, and we know the Simon Fraser team is young and just getting pushed around a bit so far in this first half. Hopefully they can respond.
Well, it's been a tough season locally for the two universities, I'll tell you. UBC going to 0-4 today. Simon Fraser still looking for that first win as well. That said, great high school football action yesterday and continuing again today. So many of the great talents we're seeing. Ryzen John at Vancouver College, Gavin Cobb at Mount Douglas, St. Thomas More, Lord Tweedsmere. So many great high schools in this area represented on this Clan roster. And great to see them coming together with the Washington State talent that Thomas Ford is bringing into this program.
Yeah, it's pretty cool to see. And, you know, Friday night football here at high school and then Saturday night football at Swangard. And we're going to do that again next week, facing Azusa Pacific, again back here at Swangard, 6 p.m. kickoff as well. So we'll be back again here
in
the booth, Howie.
We'll be back with you. And, boy, after that, we're going to have to get our programs out to remember these Clan players. They're gone for a month.
Bit of a holiday, yeah.
Four straight on the road in the
GNAC. Four straight road games, which is pretty odd if you look at a GNAC schedule, especially for football. Then coming back and playing two straight, I believe, with a bye.
They got a bye in between, which will be nice, yeah. So a big, big season ahead in the GNAC for Simon Fraser, starting next week with Azusa Pacific right here at Swangard Stadium. To join us on Clan TV. Right now, the Clan defense wanting to get a stop if they can. Here's Roth going wide to the far side of the field.
Yeah, there's a hold there, Howie. That was clean as day.
So the flags fly there. And
that's coming back.
Nonetheless, a nice open field tackle there to stop the runner by Jarrell Cummings. Yet another freshman and another player out of Notre Dame secondary.
Just waiting on the call here from these officials. They like to chat, hey, these officials.
They do.
Taking their time here. That's okay. Gives you and I more time.
That's right. That's right.
Chat as well. Here's the call. I think.
Well, you nailed that one, Nick, and a little self-destructing mode here for South Dakota.
Well, if I can see it from up here, the referee should be able to see it from down there.
That's not always the case, though.
That's a good call that goes Simon Fraser's way, obviously pushing the Hardrockers back. Now they'll go back to their more traditional four-wide set, it looks like, taking out that tight end. Roth in the backfield. We've seen this a lot tonight, the four wide look. And Zur lined up on the far left side.
There's a handoff to Roth, who's become the workhorse here, and he's going to get taken down inside the five, probably at about the 3-yard line. We'll see where they spot the football.
And they get that penalty back and more. And again, we just see
this Simon Fraser defense is
crashed down to the right and
probably getting really gassed here at this point. They have been on the field a ton here over the latter stages of the second quarter. Clan player being helped up there.
Well, that would not be good. That's our Isaac Makian.
One of the starters in that linebacking core. Isaac Muckian ripping the turf out of his helmet. He did a face plant there. He is being helped off the field.
Now down inside the five, Hardrockers bring in their heavy team. Looks like they've brought back in their tight end. It's funny how a heavy team is still three tight ends, or sorry, three receivers, but bringing in a tight end.
We're talking about Ira Murphy, 87, who scored the touchdown in this football game off the shovel pass in the first quarter. Pass to the end zone again, this time, oh.
Nice play.
And there are no flags and a great job defending down there by the pure freshman of the Notre Dame secondary, Jarrell Cummings.
Yeah, he's given about 6 inches to that guy and really great play. Punches his hands through when the ball gets there. And then once that ball's tipped, anything's fair game, Howie. Just drag him down and you can't catch it.
That's a huge confidence builder for Cummings, who has really been thrown into the fire here. Fake, they have a man wide open for the touchdown. And it's going to be Caleb Roth, number 33, making the catch with 107 left to the break. But flags are down.
Yeah, just kind of snuck Roth back in behind coverage. He almost dropped.
I thought he was going to drop that thing.
But I think two separate flags on the play here, Howie. We'll see how this shakes down. Offensive lineman there for South Dakota Mines signaling that it is a touchdown. So this may be applied after the whistle. We'll see. They'll chat about it. But boy, that's a tough break for Simon Fraser. Down just over a minute left here in the first quarter to go down three scores heading into the second half.
Starting to forget about this Klan offense. We've hardly seen them here in the second quarter.
And it's just, it's tough on a defense when you're out there for a ton of plays in a row, just sort of grinding away at the run game as the Hardrockers have been doing. That's going to tire out an offense, or sorry, a defense. Oh.
I think both of them were against South Dakota.
So they called an illegal crackback block, which negated the penalty, or sorry, negated the touchdown. And then after the play, looks like the quarterback, Toby Smith, was doing a bit of chirping.
Wow.
And was given an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. So it's going to be first and goal from the 32-yard line. Sorry, not first and goal. I think it's third and goal from the 32-yard line. I don't know if I've ever seen that before.
Wow. So Simon Fraser, the defense really tapping into the reserves early in this game, but they are pumped. And look at them getting their entire sideline involved. There's some clear clan chemistry being built here.
Just for Simon Fraser here, you don't want any play that's going to give the Hardrockers an automatic first down. Just hold them to the field goal attempt, which they would, you know, probably kick from here anyway. So do your best to wrap up. No face masks, no defensive holds, and force a field goal attempt here.
Let's just see what they do, because we've seen some balance from this South Dakota offense. Hardrockers now. Hand off to Roth, who's weaving his way through the pile. And they'll set up some better field goal position here for about a 34-yard field goal.
You know, Coach Tom Ford will take a timeout to stop the clock here in an effort to try and get the ball back for Nick Sitch with a little bit of time left. I do believe that's their final timeout. I'm not sure, actually.
Gutsy play, though. The Klan defense hanging in there. You know what?
Down to the 3-yard line and got stuffed down at the – actually allowed the touchdown, but a couple, couple of calls go their way, and now going to force a field goal attempt.
And that would be helping their cause as much as you could have expected, given the field position that South Dakota's had here in this second quarter of play. A fumble that doesn't go Simon Fraser's way, that the replay monitor clearly shows probably should have been a Simon Fraser takeaway. And of course the touchdown getting wiped off the board, two of the bigger things that have gone against the Klan, but they've manufactured some of their own breaks, right, Nick? They have been steadfast.
Yeah, and I think it's sort of evened out on this drive here. A couple penalties against the Hardrockers, and has created a situation where Hardrockers are probably going to kick a field goal here. You mentioned about a 33-yarder. The field goal kicker is Enos Sefa. He's attempted two on the day, missed one, made one, missed his longer one. I think it was about a 46-yarder, but made one from about 36, I think it was. Now he's going to attempt a 40-yard field goal here. 56 seconds left. If this goes wide, Simon Fraser can get some decent field position.
Just under a minute remaining. Snap down, kick up, and it is good.
Good leg.
So a 40-yarder goes through. At the same time, Simon Fraser has kept touchdowns off the board.
Yeah, and for this defense to be on the field for that long, I'm sure we'll see the time of possession here at the halftime stats, but it's got to be skewed towards the Hardrockers here. And now for Simon Fraser, 50 seconds left here. We'll see what Coach Tom Ford and offensive coordinator Mr. Holen have up their sleeve. See if they go for it a bit here. The Simon Fraser did receive in the first half, so the Hardrockers will most likely get the ball to start the second half. So Simon Fraser could take a shot here, and we see somebody back there who we haven't seen yet, but that's Gavin Cobb, number 11, and the other returner, Riley Morrison, we have seen back there. So maybe Ford looking for a bit of a splash play, throwing Cobb in there with just under a minute left.
Yeah, Cobb was there on a punt return, not on a kickoff return, and you're right, Nick, he's down there right on his own goal line. You wonder if they try to kick away from him, but Morrison has been effective too. Here they go. That's going to go to Cobb. Can Gavin weave some magic here? He slips through a hole. Look at him go. Oh, just shy of breaking it. You can see the special nature of Gavin Cobb right there.
He's definitely got some happy feet, Howie, and able to slip through tacklers. Nice little side juke there. And
got a, spin. The ball protection is important, too.
So Simon Fraser's got 44 seconds left here.
They've got a cache of receivers.
They don't have any timeouts, but as we know in the college game, the clock will stop on a first down, so to reset the stick. So we'll see what Nick Sitch has got here in the two-minute offense. He's only been the starter here for 2 weeks, probably a limited repertoire, but we'll see what he's got.
Quick pass to the sidelines, has a man out at the 40-yard line, Riley Morrison.
Nice confidence builder to start the drive. Morrison just a simple 5 yard out, catches the ball, gets out of bounds, stop the clock. Nice
save
play.
In time, you betcha. Simon Fraser, second and manageable, second and four at the 40. Looking downfield, slinging
got
it.
Him.
Has
got
him,
him
in. Oh, just couldn't set himself. So make the catch, Riley Morrison, number six.
And they tried that a couple times, those little wheel routes, because it seems that the Hardrockers have been biting on those outs. And he had Morrison down the field just out of the reach of his outstretched hands.
What are your thoughts here? Third and short, Nick. You just want to keep this going with 34 seconds left. Still a lot of time.
So yeah, I think you've got time to get a first down and reset and try a couple more plays. So I think you can go anywhere on the field here. But I'm going to look for Cobb over the middle.
Cobb and Ryson John to the far side of the field. They're going to go right over the middle, and a great catch there by Ethan Basalt to the 50, right at midfield, and the Klan are going to scramble here to get going. The clock now down to 25 seconds and counting. They are going to spike it. Not sure the clock stopped in time there.
Yeah, I'm not sure. It's supposed to, the clock should stop on a first down, I believe, and should reset.
Oh, we're listening to the Klan coaches a little bit unhappy about the clock here.
And 21 seconds left.
They spotted at the 49-yard line of the Klan, so just shy of midfield here. Second and 10. Nixich, trying to dig it out of the ground. Can't do it. And that looked like Pierce.
Just a bit behind that receiver. Hardrockers have an injury down there. Yeah, just a bit behind that intended receiver trying to take advantage of the middle of the field again.
Can't get the number of the Hardrocker on the field at about the Simon Fraser 42-yard line right now. 16 seconds left. So third down here, and we will take a bit of a pause here as the Hardrocker player gets up, thankfully, and it's
Gavin Chaddock made a couple plays earlier in the game. Good to see him back on his feet. It's going to be a third down here for Simon Fraser, third and 10.
16 seconds left.
It's time to get a couple plays away here.
Bryson John and Aiden Pierce, the bookend receivers here to the far and near side of the field. Nixich steps up in the pocket, delivers over the middle, has a man, and he makes the catch, Ethan Basalt. We're down to 8.8 seconds left.
Nice catch there by Basalt.
They are hustling here as the clock down to 6, and they'll spike it with 4.6 seconds left.
This would be a long field goal. Be about a 48-yarder. I don't think they're going to go that way. I think they're probably going to take a shot here into the end zone. See how big of a cannon this kid Nixich does have.
So down to one more play here for the freshman quarterback, Brandon Nixich. 4.6 seconds left. Whistles blow.
South Dakota took a timeout there.
See the Klan bringing in Casey Kircher in pass protection there.
We'll see what.
They need to put about a second and a half back there. 4.6 they'll put it to. So still one more shot here for the Klan.
Yeah, this would be quite a long field goal here, 47 yards. For Eisenkraft, so.
No, Eisenkraft hasn't hit one, but Christy Elliott hit a 40 on a dare, so. Inner skateboard shoes. Should we say that much too?
Love to see her out there. Simon Fraser looking for 7 here.
Yeah, they'll take a shot downfield here. Here comes that receiving core on the field. Rice and John taken to the far side of the field.
He would be the obvious intended receiver, but also coming in is Kester Awunze, another tall receiver.
Number 81 to the near side of the field is Awunze.
So they've got their tall receivers on the wide side. We'll see what Nixich can do and if the O-line can protect for long enough while he can sling one downfield.
Basalt and Cobb in the slots here as Nixich looks down the field, puts it up, has a man. Touchdown, Simon Fraser! Bryson John with a great catch. We do see a flag flying, but
wow.
What a catch by Bryson John. Going up over two defenders to rip that one away. What's with all these flags after the scores, though? Boy, look at this catch by Rising John. We'll get a good shot of it here. Two guys in the end zone.
Nice pass, too, and Rising John makes the catch.
John pulls it down in between two defenders. Touchdown's going to count.
What a play by the Klan. I'm a little gun-shy after what happened with Gavin Cobb. I apologize to the Klan Nation out there, but a great catch. And Simon Fraser gets on the board. What a great job to manage that clock and get down the field by the Klan and the Magic Man. Rice and John rises.
And it is Eisenkraft in for the extra point, Howie.
Eisenkraft will try to finish this playoff. And he boots it through. What a tremendous finish Simon Fraser's defense deserves a huge tip of the hat here. They held South Dakota to two field goals.
Well, that could be our turning point here, Howie. Hold South Dakota just a field goal there with under a minute, and then to drive the whole length of the field in 45 seconds, getting a Hail Mary touchdown from Rising John. What a way to end the first half. And Simon Fraser only down 13-7 here as we go into the half.
Wow, what a job. Rising John, such a special player, and you see him being congratulated by his teammates as he walks off the field. What a terrific finish to this opening half of play. Folks, we got a football game here. You don't go anywhere. 13-7, the Hardrockers with a lead. It's Howard and Nick here from Swangard Stadium. We'll be back in a few moments with some of the numbers. We'll take a short break and be back with more from Swangard Stadium.
That's temporary. Any goal that you achieve that you have for yourself, that's forever.
And welcome back, everybody, to Swangard Stadium. Howard Samura along. Ooh, sorry about that. A little cramped in the press box here. Along with Nick Sersky, our analyst. And Nick, take a look at those numbers and what jumps out at you from the opening half of play.
Really, it was a point of contention in the first half. Simon Fraser just defending the run game. Both running backs averaging over 5 yards a carry. Roth with 7.1 and Ahmad Lewis with 5.1. Toby Smith has looked okay at times, 11 for 17. But really, Simon Fraser not getting much going on the ground. Like Solomon Hines, 9 rushes for 24 yards. Nick Sitch has looked poised, looked really good, hasn't made any bad decisions. Really is loving Cobb. Cobb obviously had that big one for the 73-yarder with the penalty gets called back. But spreading the ball around, Cobb's got 4 receptions. Basalt and Morrison have 3. And Ryzen John, that big one, and then the big touchdown as well. So it's going to be an interesting second half. I think Simon Fraser knows that they're in a ball game here. And, this is not a team like they've played in the past 2 weeks that's going to, pound them into the ground here. So defensively, they had a tough first quarter, and really that last drive of the second quarter where the Hardrockers were really able to run it down the throats of Simon Fraser. Simon Fraser looked like they made some adjustments, brought some more run blitzes early in that second quarter, but then that last drive, but thankfully Simon Fraser able to hold them to a field goal attempt. So, offensively, Simon Fraser's done some good things. The run game hasn't quite been as effective as probably Coach Ford has wanted it to be, but Nick Sitch has looked good and hasn't made any mistakes, and that's what you want from a quarterback.
And I got to ask you this, Nick. If you're Thomas Ford, how do you determine when to or how much resource and how many snaps do you put into trying to get that running game going in the second half versus, hey, we've got Ryzen John? I mean, really, I think everybody knew Ryzen John was going to be thrown at there at the end, and he still caught the football.
Yeah, 100%. Nick Sitch threw it up in a double coverage, and the Hardrockers just had it ripped away from them in the end zone. And you play the run to keep the defense honest, but the offensive line had a bit of a push. Midway through that first quarter, had a bit of a push offensively, but since then there hasn't been much. I guess time will tell how much they will run the ball. You need to keep them honest, because with a rookie quarterback, you can't just expect the defensive line to pin their ears back and pass rush Nick Sitch till the cows come home. So I think he's got to stay somewhat balanced, but Nick Sitch has done a good job, and James Holland and the offensive team have created a good scheme where, even if they're not running the ball, they're giving him quick throws to the flats over the middle that are quick, easy reads, and if it's there, boom, throw it and get that completion. It's almost like an extended run.
You talked about Nick Sitch. A great point, too, that, he hasn't really hurt himself out there. He was 16 of 34 for 250 last week. So, just under 50%. But look at his completion coming up.
And that's what you want.
Start.
He hasn't taken any really big negative plays. He hasn't taken any big sacks. He hasn't fumbled. He hasn't thrown any picks. And they're right in this game. They're just down by 6. So from a freshman quarterback, I'm very impressed with the poise he's got in the pocket. He's been pressured on a couple dropbacks here and there, and he's been able to escape. Yeah, he sacked a couple times, but smart, protecting the ball, doesn't throw it up into double, triple coverage unnecessarily. So I've been impressed with Nick Sitch, and I think he's only going to get better as this game goes on and as this season goes along if he's going to be the starter the rest of the way out. I'm excited.
Gavin Cobb is a electric player on the field. When something like that happens, Nick, and you played this game at the university level in Canada, when you have something like that happen to you, can that be enough to really convince you to rein it in and not do that kind of stuff?
Well, and I think, from his perspective, you obviously feel bad that you've taken a score off the board, and you felt the energy drop in the stadium as well. And you know what? I think he feels that. He's still a young guy, still maturing as a young student athlete here at Simon Fraser. And you know what? These are the things that he's going to learn from, and the things that he's going to take with him in his life. So yeah, he probably regrets his decision, and the points are going to be off the board. I guarantee he's not going to do it again. If he goes into the end zone, I think he's just going to, in the second half, I think he's just going to sprint in and keep his head down. So, these are learning experiences for young athletes, and he's excited. He was back. He made a big play. He put points up on the board. The first touchdown of the game for Simon Fraser to get them tied up. And So I get it. You know, he's an emotional. It was an emotional play, and he made a great play and got the catch. And so, you know what? It's a learning experience for him, and something that he'll build on as the season goes
and
along.
And clearly, everyone in the stadium doing the math. If that touchdown counted, you know, you can't say for sure, but 14-13, the Clan would be up at this point, pending that extra point if it had all gone through. But as you say, Nick, right in this game, as we get down to about 20 seconds before the start of this one. And we'll see what the Clan can do here in the second half, looking for their first win of the season and their first D2 victory since 2014. So a long dry spell, potentially ready to come off the books here with a great second half from the home team, the guys in red.
And you'll notice a bit of a short field here already for Simon Fraser. There was an unsportsmanlike conduct call against an offensive lineman. I think it was 78, Elder, after that touchdown. Rising John's touchdown. So Simon Fraser will be kicking off from their own 20. Hopefully they can cover this kick well and stop the Hard Rockers from, you know, getting up to the 40-yard line or so.
Ball protection and keep your head and don't hurt yourself. Two big keys
and
here, I think, for this Clan team.
And it's cliche, Howie, but it's the key to every football game, especially if you're a young team that's going to be relying on a freshman quarterback. You can't make mistakes. You can't compound problems that you have. And so don't take penalties. Don't turn the ball over. And you know what? You can be in any game.
Simon Fraser set now to kick off to get us going here. And fielded at the 20. That is Quarter Cropsey. And they are getting a great return here past midfield.
Yeah, good return there. It just sort of set up a bit of a wall to the left. You see the Hard Rockers really creating a nice gap there for number 22, Cropsey, to run through. And, great start here for the Hard Rockers. Simon Fraser defense back at it once again, and going to have to try and prevent the Hard Rockers from getting too many first downs here to prevent a score.
Toby Smith, the redshirt sophomore quarterback, who managed things well in that opening half of play for the visitors, will start the second half. He's got Ahmad Lewis, the freshman running back, paired with him in the backfield. They'll fake a little handoff. Scrambling to the far side of the field and throwing that one away. Good pressure there by the Clan in the backfield.
Yeah, and great coverage downfield too. And you saw the receiver sort of slip. We can see it's a bit of a slick field down there. As we did mention, there was some rain earlier in the day. Created a slick ball and a slick field. But Smith just rolls to his right, didn't see anything, threw the ball away.
Simon Fraser right in this game with that last second play to Rice and John, a 30-yard touchdown pass. Here come the Hard Rockers, though, with Lewis trying to hurdle his man. Can't do it. And it was Matt Duda getting in there to prevent the first down.
Yeah, just putting the defensive end there in a pinch. That's 59 Jackson, who's made a couple good plays earlier in the day, but the Hard Rockers are just kind of putting him on an island there, making him decide between Lewis and pressuring the quarterback, and he gets a good gain of 5 yards.
Third and five at the 37-yard line. It's a completion to the near sideline, and that is number 18, Joe Lubers, with a catch.
Boy, and it looked like Simon Fraser had pretty good coverage there. He thought if that was number eight, if I thought Jarrell Cummings could have come through the arms there and maybe knocked that one away, but good completion there. Tight window for Smith to complete that to Lubers.
Clan hanging around, and this Clan defense really set the stage for that Rising John touchdown at the end of the half. They want to do more of the same here, but this Hard Rockers offense is grinding out the yards again with the freshman up the middle. And Ahmad Lewis, what a game he's having.
And that was Jackson on that. Right side just gets plowed over by number 75, the tackle who pulled Grant Smith, and created a nice lane for Lewis.
Yeah, they're road graders up front there on that offensive line for the Hard Rockers, who are slowly making their way downfield. Here's Lewis again, met by a host of Clan tacklers, but doing his best to get what he can. It's going to create, I think, a third and short here.
And you see it here, Howie. Like, even when they get good penetration, it's still Lewis still pushes 2-3 yards and gets carried by one of his own offensive linemen to create a third and short. That's a great play by the Hard Rockers.
So here they come. They keep marching. This time they'll take Lewis off tackle. He strains and stretches for an extra yard or two there.
I think he's going to be short, Howie. This will be an interesting decision here for the Hardrockers.
Yeah, I think they held him.
It's going to be fourth and short. It's a makeable field goal, but it looks like the offense is going to stay on the field here. And a big stop here for Simon Fraser if they can make it.
Fourth and one for the Hardrockers. We had some movement there. A throw to the end zone. It's not going to be there.
And boy, the head coach of the Hardrockers is not happy. I think he thought Simon Fraser jumped there and just sort of didn't. Not a great read, not a great throw by Smith. Throws it away, and Simon Fraser able to get the turnover on downs. Big stop here to start the third quarter.
Yeah, and I can't, we haven't had a replay right of the two lines there, but definitely there was some movement there on the line.
You couldn't tell if they jumped, you know, into the neutral zone, which would, of course, be a penalty, or if they just sort of stood up at the you know, before the snap. But great job by Simon Fraser.
Well, in late downs, this Clan defense has been dynamic here, and they did it again. Oh, and this one is going to get picked off straight into the arms of a Hard Rock player, and he's going to go right into the end zone. And that is Will Carroll, the sophomore, and that's a backbreaker for the Simon Fraser Clan.
Just read him like a book, Howie. That was Nick Schitch's first read and just jumped that slant route. I believe it was to Cobb. And just was able to pick it off, and you see the defense there celebrating. We'll see the replay here. Nixus just pulls that, looks to his left, and right into the arms of the waiting Hard Rocker defender.
Wow. Well, Will Carroll won't score an easier one than that. They were lined up like they were going to go for two, but they now will kick the single.
Yeah, I think we mentioned before the game, the Hard Rockers had five interceptions on the season, now this being their sixth. And a couple ball hawks in that secondary. Great play by the Hard Rockers there to negate that big stop defensively for
wow.
Simon Fraser. That's a tough break here for Nixitch, but you know what? It's
a
over.
A real tough break.
It's done. You know what? You gotta move on and move past that. You have to have a short memory as a young quarterback. You're going to get the ball back in good field position. And hopefully, for Simon Fraser, you can put a drive together, put some points on the board, and get back within one score.
So one of the moments of adversity now for the Simon Fraser Clan, you stop the opposition on fourth down. The next snap, you hand it right to them and give them a clear path right to the end zone. A tough break there for Simon Fraser. You just mentioned that Brandon Nixitch had not done anything to hurt himself, and the young man really having a good game until that pass. And it'll be key to see how he bounces back and how he learns from the pick six.
Well, we talked about adversity with the decision by Cobb on the penalty too, and Nixitch is going to have to bounce back from this if he wants to implement himself as the starting quarterback for the rest of the season. He's going to have to make some big throws down the way, and he's going to have to bounce back from throwing picks. You know what? Not every quarterback's going to go interception-free in a season, right?
Line drive right to Cobb at his own 5-yard line, dancing, freeing himself, and trying to get out of that pile. You can see how close Cobb is coming on all of these to breaking them. But he's going to get up to about the 24-yard line, I believe.
And just his ability to reverse field, Howie. Yeah. He was going straight to the left and just had a nice cutback and had some Hard Rockers over pursue. Fortunately, able to get it to about the 25-yard line where Simon Fraser will take over.
BC AAA Subway Bowl MVP, much the same as the quarterback in waiting here as well, Gideon Kremler, for the Mount Douglas Rams, two of the greatest players in program history now suiting up for the Clan. That's Hines, the handoff, and he works hard for a minimal gain.
Keeps fighting. You know what? This Hines kid, he's not going down on first contact, but there's just not a ton there.
2 years ago, the Washington State 200-meter sprint champion. And you know what? You see sprinters in football, but I don't know how many of them run right up the middle like this kid does. He's a tough kid. If he breaks it, look out. He is a speedster. Oh, and that's a nice catch by the Clan. Looks like they got a first down there. Ethan Basalt.
Yeah, we'll see it here on the replay. Again, just that simple zone read that I actually didn't fake the handoff there, but Nixus just looks over to his left. Basalt on that quick slant. Nice completion, easy pitch and catch.
Great hands, runs great routes. He's that Amendola type of guy in your offense. Great job there by Ethan Basalt. Here's Hines. Just can't get it going on first down.
It's a classic Detroit Lions fan reference there, hey?
It's his first year.
Just slip
there.
That in here, Danny Amendola.
Big game against the Eagles tomorrow for my guys. And they're actually showing the Detroit Lions on TV tomorrow, so I'm happy about
that.
There
you go.
Simon Fraser on second down, second and eight. Hines, again up the middle, has a nice little crease, and he's going to get close to the marker, probably about 2 or 3 yards shy.
Yeah, that's a bit better from Simon Fraser. Hines hits that hole hard, and 55 was able to kick out there and create a bit of a gap for Hines to get 4 or 5 yards and create a nice third down opportunity for Simon Fraser.
Third and about 2.5 here for the Clan. They'll go again, and this time the ball is loose. Simon Fraser, luckily, from their perspective, are going to get it back. Falling on it, I believe number 70 will fall on that football and save the Clan there.
Boy, that was a great hit by that. I think that was the linebacker, 59.
Wow.
Brockenmeyer.
Nick Giffen, the Holy Cross product, able to pounce on that loose football. So
nice play by Brockenheimer. Put his helmet on the ball and popped that one out. Kircher didn't really have much time to make a move.
And he's been old school with some of his hits on defense today, Brockenheimer.
Some movement there.
So Simon Fraser getting the nice first down on that catch by Basalt, but just can't string the first downs together here.
Again, a bit of a discussion here from the referees. It's offside against the Hardrockers, so fortunately it won't quite give Simon Fraser a first down, but a fourth and two, it makes it a little bit more interesting, but this stage of the game in your own end, you probably don't go for it.
A little too deep still.
Fourth and two and a half.
So Metzeler will put boot to ball here.
Oh, boy.
Ooh, takes a nice Hardrocker bounce there. Just dies at about the 40-yard line. Flags everywhere. Have you seen that much nylon?
All that looked like from one interaction, too. That was...
Wow, it just rained down.
Didn't see who it was from the Hardrockers, but it was number 53 from Simon Fraser, Jordan Russell, getting into it with somebody. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 flags on the field that I can see. Take some time to sort this one out. Not a great kick by Metzeler. And not a great snap by the long snapper. Couldn't get that number, but we might see a bit of the tiff here. Here we can see right in the middle of the screen, that's 89 and 53 going at it. And some Hardrockers come to his defense. Oh, there's a shot to the head. That's going to be a penalty every time.
Jordan Russell, the freshman outside linebacker.
So that'll set Simon Fraser back a little bit here. Wonder if it'll be an offsetting penalty to the Hardrockers as well. We'll see. We see Coach Tom Ford in his second year with Simon Fraser. 1-9 last season with the big win over Willamette, Division III opponent.
A fun night up on the hill to start the season last year. But I think that record deceptive. There were some real moments for the Clan to have their breakthrough in the GNAC schedule.
Got a hold on Simon Fraser, and then an unsportsmanlike call against Simon Fraser. And then now an unsportsmanlike, an offsetting one against the Hardrockers. We're having some trouble picking up the microphone here in the booth, so I'm doing my best to describe it to you guys. But so it looks like those unsportsmanlike conduct penalties will offset, but the holding call will take it back about 10 yards. Or not about. We'll take it back 10 yards. For Simon Fraser, the Hardrockers are going to take over at midfield, and boy, another short field for this defense. And it's what we've seen a couple times tonight, and you know, they've stepped up to the occasion more than once. But it's only a matter of time if you're giving the Hardrockers such short fields that that they're going to score some major points here. So hopefully Simon Fraser's got another big stop in them, and this defensive line and set of linebackers can stop this run from Lewis.
Yeah, we just don't want the dam to break from a Klan perspective. The Klan defense has been pretty darn consistent given their plight. Lost a helmet out there.
Wow. Really collapsed down there. Simon Fraser did a good job of plugging up that hole. Lewis, look at him. He, even with no helmet, thought that the play was supposed to get blown dead if a helmet came off from an active player. But he will have to come off the field for a play to get that helmet restrapped on. So we'll see Roth back in the game. Roth actually having a better night in terms of average. He did catch a touchdown pass, but was then overturned by that block in the back and the taunting penalty late in the second quarter. We'll
Caleb
see what
Roth,
he can do.
Number 33, you're right, is out there right now, and he loves to just go hard up the middle. Oh, and we're getting some Klan pressure, and the best defensive series in the backfield of the Hardrockers tonight.
And just keep working. We see Barrett coming around the side, and 59 as well. That's Jackson.
Thomas Jackson doing some nice work back there.
And just keep working, keep fighting through those blocks. If the coverage is good down the field, you're going to get time to get to Smith here, and they did so on that play.
This dedicated Klan defense, third and
10. Look for him to throw.
Well,
and they did.
They did.
Great
they
play.
Snuff
great
it
play.
Out. They got to get the man down. They do, and a great job by this Klan defense.
Fantastic way not to bite on that play. We could see it from up here, Howie. That throw from Smith was clearly a lateral to Lewis, and we saw a receiver break down the field. I'm not sure who it was. I think it was 84 Hotson break down the field, but Simon Fraser didn't bite on that, had a defensive back on Hotson and rallied up to Lewis to create that tackle. A big negative play. That's a big stop.
Big play. And now Gavin Cobb back to try and weave his magic, but the Klan defense has been stellar. Going to take a bounce and die at about the 25-yard line. So Cobb unable to get a return on it. But once again, Nick, Simon Fraser's
defense. And defensively,
defense.
That's all you can ask for Simon Fraser. Sorry to interrupt, Howie.
No, that's good.
But when you take the ball over at the 50 and you go negative, that's exactly what Simon Fraser wants here. So now for Simon Fraser offensively, haven't seen much success here in the second half. Get back to basics. Let's run a couple plays. Get some pickups, some first downs for Nixich. Maybe he's getting a little bit of happy feet from his pick six that he threw earlier in this quarter. But he looked good in the first. Let's get back to that.
Klan hanging around at 20-7 down. They go to Hines up the middle. Solomon pushing hard but gaining about 3 yards. So Solomon Hines getting a real workout.
You know, he keeps fighting too. He's not the biggest frame guy. Like he's not like Lewis. Who I think, you know, Lewis is 5'11", 200 pounds. He's a bit smaller of a frame, but he keeps those legs churning.
Stronger than he looks, and that is for sure.
Love to see them get him the ball a little bit more space too, with maybe some throws to the flat, some screens, something to get him in space and where he can really show off that speed. Wonder if that's coming, Howie. Maybe that's a foreshadow. I don't know.
Maybe. But definitely some dialogue there between Rice and John and Brandon Nixich on the sidelines. Up there scheming something and drawing something out in the sand there before this play.
Yeah, let's do that Hail Mary play again. That was a good one. Yeah.
It's a handoff, and it's Solomon Hines, and very little there, maybe a yard to bring on third and probably about six.
Yeah, just not much there. Bring the tight end across to down block. Hines bounces it outside, but again, a host of Hardrockers there. They do rally to the ball very well. I've noticed the Hardrockers really, you know, always four or five guys in there trying to rip that ball out.
They're bringing the gold hats to the ball, and here they are again on third and five, they'll call it. Nixich stands in the pocket, eludes some pressure, shakes off a tackle, finds an outlet in Kircher. KC is going to get taken down right at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, and just not much down the field, Howie. And Nixich steps up, breaks a tackle, but there's just not much there. downfield, and you know, with that pressure, he couldn't really get his eyes downfield anyway. And Kircher's the outlet pass, and the Hardrockers rally up and make a tackle. Three and out here for Simon Fraser.
I need Simon Fraser's special teams now to make a bit of a dint here to give their defense a bit of a break. See if they can't make something happen here. Keith Metzeler.
Better snap this time and a pretty good kick.
Fair catch called for at about the 38-yard line by Ulrich. Anthony Ulrich, number 11. So Simon Fraser really wanting to get things going offensively. They're 7 points tonight, coming on the last play of the first half, a 30-yard Hail Mary down the field to Rice and John. The amount of snaps this Klan defense has seen tonight is certainly skewed. Here's a handoff to Lewis, and he's going to be a battering ram and break a tackle. And the Klan lucky to find a way to stop him at about their own 41-yard line.
Boy, what a tackle he breaks there. Like, he is in the grasp of two Klan defenders and just breaks away, keeps those legs churning.
It's a low center of gravity. It's lowering your pads,
big,
and it's
hit there by Dawson Marchanto. Nice hit.
Here he is again. Why not feed him? This time he's driven back by a host of Klan tacklers.
It was Jackson, I think, with the first contact there. It wasn't Jackson.
And as well, Crescenzo in there. Rolling to the sidelines, and a great job there by the Klan to pursue.
There you go. Good to see Barrett back in the game. He's good pursuit there by Griffin Barrett. He's the new Jordan Herdman of this team. He's the
around the ball. You're right. Just around the ball.
He's got a nose
for
the ball a lot, yeah.
And I believe that was Isaac Evans that forced Smith out of bounds. Toby Smith, a redshirt sophomore, so his first start, Nixich's second start at this NCAA Division II level, so two raw quarterbacks in the game today. Smith guns it down the field, has a man, couldn't squeeze it. And looking for Joe Lubers.
Boy, and he was there. Lubers just sort of ran an over-the-middle route, a crossing route there. And just sort of, Smith could have dropped it a little bit more over that linebacker. I think that was a pretty fairly easy completion. But luckily for Simon Fraser, weren't able to make the connection. And again, force a nice three and out.
You got to think the football gods are going to pay some homage here to SFU, that they're going to get a big one here one of these times, Nick, from Gavin Cobb, and he's back again. Cobb, number 11, standing at about his 10-yard line. A little bit of a drop kick down
the
field.
Old rugby-style kick that we see a little bit more often here in the college game, and a nice kick.
Nice job there doing what they need to do. And they'll field it at about the 5 or 6 yard line. So the Klan with a long field. And they're doing their best to keep the ball out of the hands of Gavin Cobb.
Really good job defensively, I think, for both teams here, making some adjustments at halftime. We really haven't seen the offenses be in sync as much as they were in the first half. But Simon Fraser now with their third drive of this third quarter. No first downs yet in this third quarter, so hoping to get one here and get out of the shadow of their own goalpost.
Well, they did get one with the basalt.
You're right. Yes.
Slant pattern, but other than that, really not anything. Now, this is what I was asking you at the start. How long do you invest snaps in the running game at this point?
Clearly, at least the first three drives. Good insight, Nick. Yeah, thanks. But you got to keep the defense honest, and if you're going to run some RPOs, you're going to have to run the ball every once in a while.
Kester Owunze is now out there, and he's going to make a catch. Nice grab there for a nice gain. It'll set up third and short. So Wunze off the sideline, gets into the game cold and makes a nice catch here. Third and one for the Clan here deep in their own end, and this is a must-have for the guys in red. Oh, and a nice push there.
He's got it, yeah.
Was that Kircher or was that Solomon Hines?
That was Kircher in the backfield there.
So KC Kircher, number 45, getting the tough.
Puts his head down and gets 5-6 yards. Good run there by Kircher.
KC Kircher, the sophomore out of Yuba City, California.
We saw him a bit last year as well as the backup running back. We've seen him deployed here in third down situations as some pass protection as well.
Cobb in motion. Nixich.
Yeah, he has
on the run, no. Throw, and has a man.
Good job with Cobb. They went out and did the wheel route, but it wasn't there. And Cobb recognized that Nixich was rolling out to his left, stops his route short, makes a nice catch. Brings up second down.
So positive gains on first down here for the Clan, helping their cause. Second and short. Pierce, John, and Cobb on the near side of the field. And Kircher stays in the backfield. Ooh, nowhere to go there.
Not much there, Howie. Yeah, that was Kircher, I believe, again.
Yeah, Casey Kircher stayed on the field and just had nowhere to go.
Those Hardrockers, they swarm that ball. Four or five guys down in the trenches there making a tackle, forcing an important third down conversion here for Simon Fraser. We've seen a lot of opportunities, these third down conversions. Hopefully Simon Fraser can convert.
Passing down here for the Clan. Third and four, Nixich. Middle of the field has it.
Knocked away.
Batted away there. And the frustration continuing to mount here for this Clan offense. Give the Hard Rockers credit. They are doing what they need to survive in this game. 1:21 left in the third quarter.
Again, and as we talk about with Nixich for Smith, it's the same thing on the other side. You're a freshman quarterback. Don't make any mistakes. You've got a good running game working for you. No fumbles, no sacks. You know, keep the game plan simple, and you know, you've sort of tilted the field down into the Simon Fraser way. We've kicked it back and forth a couple times here now, but Simon Fraser definitely on the negative side of this game script. So for the Hard Rockers, just keep it simple, and now you're going to get the ball back at midfield, depending on this return. And you know, the defense, as Simon Fraser's defense has stepped up, South Dakota's defense has scored the only points of this half.
Anthony Ulrich back to return as Kees Metzelaars awaits the snap. Gets off a clean, towering punt. It's going to drive Ulrich back, and he trips on the 20-yard line.
Well, that's a one way to flip the field. What a kick by Metzelaar. Wow.
Kees Metzelaar gets off his best one of the game.
It's from his own 20 to the, that's probably about a 60-yarder, Howie.
Wow. Just a cannon of a leg.
And then luckily for him, that turf's a little slick down there. We should mention it is real grass down there, not artificial turf here at Swangard. So fans who have watched us over the past couple of years up at Terry Fox Field, currently under some renovations and getting a new stadium for next fall. But the artificial turf up there, but down here at Swangard Stadium is real grass.
First and 10 at the 20.
Nice play up the middle here. We see, I think it's a new running back for, that's Caleb Roth once again, picking up his normal 5 yards on first down. And again, Smith keeping it simple, just hand the ball off and running it up the gut of the Simon Fraser defense.
Hand off this time as they keep it on the ground.
And even when Simon Fraser's bringing guys, you know, they're hitting him at the line of scrimmage, but he's still getting 2 or 3 yards after contact, breaking some tackles and getting 4 or 5. Now it's a third and short here.
That's been the edge that South Dakota's had right from the opening tip. Just able to create more in terms of creases on that offensive line. Keep that running game going and creating favorable downs here. Third and short. And a great job there again by the Hard Rockers as Caleb Roth.
Well, I thought that backside end could have Could have came downhill a little bit more. Jackson just a little bit slow to react in the guard and tackle pull and pick up a first down for the Hardrockers.
So this tested Simon Fraser defense keeps coming back for more.
They're going to get the cold tubs tonight, Howie. There'll be no offensive guys in the
Boy.
Cold tubs.
So that's going to do it for the third quarter. 20-7, a low scoring third quarter play with just the one touchdown. Simon Fraser's faithful out in great numbers here tonight at Swangard Stadium.
Yeah, pretty good crowd witnessing a pretty good game here, Howie. It's still anybody's game. And, Simon Fraser, for what it's worth, that third quarter didn't go their way exactly, but, defensively really held the Hardrockers in check, and they didn't do much as well. So we're going to come down to a fourth quarter here where anything can happen. Two-score game, and it's going to be an exciting finish.
Well, Simon Fraser, and I think you'll agree, Nick, they've been in character-building mode from basically the maybe a third of the way through the second quarter. That defense has just done everything it can to give the offense a chance here.
Yeah, no, they've been excellent tonight. This defense has been given some short fields, has been dealt some tough breaks, but they've done a great job of digging their heels in and stopping the Hardrockers' offense.
So here they go, first and 10 to start the fourth quarter. Toby Smith, the quarterback, stays in. Play fake, a pass, and oh, almost picked off. Simon Fraser had that diagnosed Brendan Lowry from his safety spot, almost picked that one off, Nick.
And that's what you want from the backside of your defensive secondary, is to read that deep middle in there. Good coverage there. Surprised Smith forced that in, but Lowry, was able to make a play on that ball and knock it away.
Second and 10 now. This time they will hand it off, and a slip in the backfield there for Caleb Roth is going to create a tricky third down here for the Hardrockers.
And Simon Fraser brought some heat there. We'll see it off this left end. Duda comes up, and that's number 16, Crescenzo, the outside linebacker, junior from Notre Dame, created some havoc in the backfield and a third down and long here for Simon Fraser.
Can the Clan hold it together for one big down here and try to flip the field here? A big play in this football game as Smith tucks it, wants to run, loses his balance. And Simon Fraser's defense does a terrific job.
Boy, I thought I saw a face mask from up here up on the quarterback, but luckily...
Just
the side of the helmet, maybe not quite the face mask, but a good tackle, good job there by Ian Crocker coming up from his linebacker position to create another 3-0 for Simon Fraser's defense. Great job tonight.
They're doing a great job, and they're just like the Energizer Bunny. Hate the cliches, but they just keep on coming at you. They've been on the field for a ton of snaps here, a lot of times in real tough situations, and the points they've denied this Hardrocker team have made this a football game. Another placement kick is going to go downfield. Fair catch called for, and that was Gavin Cobb.
Speaking of Cobb, he's got five catches on the night for over 100 yards. He's definitely been Nixich's favorite target here. But now as the fourth quarter starts, Nixich 18 for 26, one pick, was returned for the touchdown, that one touchdown to Ryzen John as well. Only been sacked twice, has done a good job of getting out of pressure. And just this run game, and I don't know if we'll see it as much here in the fourth, as Simon Fraser is going to have to stretch the field a bit more. I was expecting a couple more shots downfield, and I think we'll have to see that here in the fourth if Simon Fraser wants to move the ball with any effectiveness.
Well, I mean, you saw a 30-yard Hail Mary. How many explosive plays can you say Simon Fraser's had, and you need those to win a football game? We'll see what we can do here with the Clan in the fourth quarter. Here's Nixich. Ooh, and he's in trouble, and he's going to go down. The sack by the Hardrockers on Simon Fraser's first possession. That's number 38, and that's Thomas Chapman with the sack. This looked a little too easy. So it looks like a second and 20. So the Clan deep in their own end here. Here's Cobb. Can he make something happen? He will be snowed on immediately by the Hardrockers.
And just a bit slow to develop that screenplay. And Cobb sort of bobbled it. You see it there. And not able to cut up as quickly as probably he wanted to. Creating a third and long here for Simon Fraser.
And you might have to start taking some chances here on third and long if you want to make something happen. Still the clock, lots of time left in the game. Perhaps too early for that. But, boy, that defense. ...12:40 remaining in this football game, 20-7. Hardrockers here on third and 20. Nixitch has a man right through his hands. That was intended for Ryan Naylor, but some tight defensive coverage there provided by the Hardrockers.
And it's really tough when it's, you know, third and 20. You try and force it down the field as much as you can. I think even if that was completed, not going to be a first down. But Simon Fraser, offensively, again, just not really.
The sack on first down just kills all the momentum.
That's a big negative play for Simon Fraser, and just not able to get anything else going.
So the Clan defense doing its job, but the Clan offense unable to.
Oh boy.
Keep them off the field. This time a snap over the head of Metzelaars, and he's going to do what he can. He just puts it up a short one, takes a bit of a Clan bounce, but this is not going to work out well. Wow. So a snap over the head of Metzelaar.
He gets the kick away. You often see in those situations the punter just eat it and give up the safety. This does keep it a two-score game, Howie, but... Simon Fraser defensively, this is the shortest field they've had all game, and they're going to have to come up with another big stop.
I'm convinced only Canadian football people give up safeties. and I'm not kidding you, because we saw Kelly Bates do it a number of times, and the U.S. announcers could not for the life of them figure out what was going on.
That snap goes over his head. Boy, I don't...
No, you're right about that, though.
I don't know how that's not... roughing the kicker as he gets hit, and as he gets it away, I understand that he's scrambling, but I thought he could still get protected. But nonetheless, a short field here for the Hardrockers. So I'm afraid you're gonna have to come up big here.
Yeah, a real turning point in this game potentially if the Hardrockers can find the end zone. 20-7, only one touchdown scored thus far in the second half. It's by the Hardrockers. Here's Smith looking downfield. Getting pressured. Are you kidding me?
Wow.
Matt Duda keeps his feet inbounds, bats it to a teammate, Nick. What a play by the Clan. Matt Duda, like he was saving a basketball inbounds in the West Gym, does it on the field here.
We've seen this before, Howie. Down in college, getting knocked back into the field of play. I didn't know if his feet... touchdown inbounds, but it looks like they're giving Simon Fraser the ball. What a play, Howie.
Well, I'd love to see a replay of that. Maybe they don't have one, but boy, Duda, and he's got the belt on the sideline. So Simon Fraser's defense comes through again.
Needed it.
Batted interception, turnover.
Here he goes.
Solomon Hines with a huge run. He's going to get to the 40. They cannot drag him down. They finally take him down at the 36-yard line. That is a huge run for the Simon Fraser Clan.
Well, we were wrong, Howie. Patience pays off. Run the ball again on first down, and just the hole opened up, and we saw that speed.
Wow.
Saw the speed that Hines has, and that straight ahead speed.
Simon Fraser now with some tempo. They are already snapping the ball here. Hines dancing and gaining maybe 2 yards on that play, but what an explosive play.
Two huge plays back-to-back, really flipping the script on this half and of this game. Simon Fraser needs a score here. Obviously two scores to get back into this game, but moving the sticks here a bit.
Second and 8 from the 35. Nixitch Quick hitter tipped. Oh, almost picked off. Simon Fraser counts himself lucky there that that wasn't picked off.
Boy, probably should have been, Howie. We'll see it on the replay.
Sure. Off the hands of the receiver. There's two defensive backs right there.
Looks to his right, and Cobb's his first read, and that's a high throw. You know, Cobb's not rising John. He's not going to be able to get up as high as that. Luckily for Simon Fraser, it falls incomplete.
Jackson,
now third down.
Yeah, Jackson and Nolasco each had shots at that tip.
You assume it's going to be four down territory here, Howie, with the state of the score. So Simon Fraser can probably get a little something here.
Coming back to the ball, his first catch of the game is Robert. Oh, no, that's Rice and John, apparently. Yes, Rice and John, apologies, rather.
Now brings up an interesting decision here.
It's going to be about
fourth and seven. It looks like Simon Fraser's offense is going to stay on the field. Boy, John just not able to cut up. Just had that defensive back from the South Dakota come in.
Nick Sitch trying to escape the pressure. Back pedals. Is in trouble.
Throw it up.
And the fourth down play will go nowhere for the Clan. A tough break off the Matt Duda heroics. But the Clan can't cash in.
Tough break on fourth down there, Howie. Just not enough time to set his feet and get a good throwaway. Didn't even really have a chance on that one.
So the ball will turn over on downs, and South Dakota School of Mines with another chance here to add to their second half lead.
But hey, the field is flipped now. Hardrockers going to have to put a drive together to milk some clock here and keep this lead. Hopefully for Simon Fraser, they can either create another turnover like they had last drive or another three and out.
Well, this defense seems to be getting stronger as the game goes along, despite the amount of time they're spending on the field.
And I think really now in the fourth quarter, they're stacking the box, selling out for the run. You see 8-9 defenders in the box there for Simon Fraser. A lot of hats on the ball. And I think that's what this fourth quarter is going to be. Hardrockers know their strength. Simon Fraser knows what the Hardrockers are going to do. I don't think they're going to let Smith really sling it around out there. So it's going to be interesting to see how this fourth quarter rolls on.
They go to Lewis this time. He's going to maybe gain a yard. So Simon Fraser bearing down here on defense, creating a third and six, I guess it'll be.
And that's all you want for a freshman quarterback, right? A young quarterback. Smith making his first career start. Third manageable here.
Are they going to keep it on the ground? No, they will go to the air. Short little quick hitter, and it's going to go. And who was that? That was number 84 for South Dakota. Carson Hunt, he was carrying Dawson Marchant down the field.
Yep, just his first read, a quick slant in. Simon Fraser committing to the run, threw it over the linebackers and a nice catch.
Well, the yak yards there include a piggyback as Dawson Marchant jumped on, did everything he could, but big tight end. Able to get a first down and more past midfield. So first and 10, South Dakota Mines here from their Clan 48-yard line. Smith will go back to the security blanket, and that is Lewis, the freshman running back, who's going to gain about four.
Boy, even when they plug up the hole on the right side, there's just no backside pursuit. You have your quarterback lead blocking. That's not exactly what you want on every play, but Lewis still able to make 4 yards out of really a run that should have went nowhere.
Second and six. Like a clock ticking here, the Hardrockers continue down the field. Consistent run game between the tackles is paying dividends for them here tonight. Another short little gain is going to bring up third and about four.
Yeah, this is what they're going to want to do. Run the clock, use that play clock. And try and get out of here with a victory. So for Simon Fraser defensively, big third down stop here. We saw a pass on the last third down conversion, a nice little quick in. A quick slant. We'll see what Smith has drawn up here.
It's just so hard to get the takeaways with this kind of an offense here, just grinding at you. There's a feeling of inevitability here as it goes to third down. Fake it to Roth.
Nice coverage.
Great job there by Brendan Lowry from his safety position. path intended
SFU
for
brought Aldridge. brought some heat, so Smith knew he had to get rid of it quickly. And that's exactly Brennan Lowry on a really good job not to pull or tug at the jersey and finally stop this Hard Rocker drive. Hopefully no points scored, no penalties here.
7:44 remaining. Gavin Cobb about to return the punt, standing at his 10-yard line.
That'll be a touchback.
Touchback there. And clearly they just don't want Cobb getting a handle on the football.
A little rugby scrum kick. Good, nice play there.
Wow,
by
close, too.
22 almost. Cropsey almost pulled it back in, but all for naught. And Simon Fraser will take over the 20-yard line.
All the clock certainly starting to become an issue, and it was when the Clan got into fourth downs on the last play, as you said, Nick. So maybe need to play with a bit more tempo, a bit more desperation, and maybe start taking some more risks in the passing game. Solomon Hines again lined up in the backfield. Trips to the near side of the field. Little draw play is going to get some real positive yards for Solomon Hines. He's going to go for about 12 or 13 yards right up the middle.
Yeah, nice play. Just a bit of a delay draw there, and Hines able to find the hole. Breaks through for a first down. Could have had more if he would have broken that tackle.
Really playing to his strengths as well. So a great job there by Hines. Back-to-back first downs would be a nice place for the Clan to start. They go to the sideline. Rice and John makes a nice catch. And this looking more like their hurry-up offense towards the end of the first half.
Yeah, and I think this is what we're going to see for the rest of the game, how he is up-tempo and just trying to get as many plays in as he can and nick stitch some quick throws and hopefully try and test this secondary down the field.
Oh, there's some. Is he Casey Kircher? Makes a nice cut, and Kircher is going to go for a first down. So the Clan running game really energized on this drive, Nick.
Yeah, they're looking good, Howie. It's a bit of a different look there with Kircher in the backfield, but able to make a nice cut and leap over a couple defenders, get that first down.
Clan finding the creases they want and making the run game count here. This time, a quick pass, and it's going to go for about a one-yard loss. And that's Ryan Naylor, number 13.
Well, I thought he had him, but just one block got missed there. And number 49 rallies up to the ball. That's Keontae Christian. Nice tackle there in the backfield.
Basically back to the line of scrimmage. They call it a loss of one. So second and 11 now for the Clan at their own 48-yard line. Brandon Nixich, the pure freshman quarterback out of Federal Way, Washington. Number 17 rears back, has a man. Oh, and right into the hands of the Hard Rockers, and they are getting a huge return down the field. Can they stop them? They will, but what huge damage inflicted.
No, they don't, Howie. That's a touchdown.
They keep going.
Oh, no. Let's see. Oh, yeah, touchdown. Touchdown, Hard Rockers.
Wow. So South Dakota off the pick, Dominic Jackson. And take a look at this. If they show the play, it looked like Basalt stopped on the play. I'm not too sure what happened.
Yeah, Basalt just wasn't looking back for it. And Dominic Jackson.
Wow.
Picks it off and the second pick six. Look at this effort to get in the end zone. Good job there by Jackson.
I thought for sure they had him, and he just keeps on going.
Hops over a couple Clan players and into the end zone, and that about salts this one away, Howie.
Wow. So 26-7 now, pending the extra point for the Hard Rockers.
Looks like they might go for two here, Howie. get it up to a full three-score advantage.
Indeed, going for two here.
Whistles here. I think they called a timeout.
So the South Dakota School of Mines on back-to-back pick six touchdowns now. Both of their touchdowns, Nick, in the second half coming off of pick six plays. Will Carroll with that 17-yard interception return to make it 20-7, and now Dominic Jackson doing the same thing on an even bigger play.
And Simon Fraser was finally rolling there on offense and just not able to, Basalt just didn't quite turn in time, and the throw was a bit behind from Nixich, and took it all the way to the house.
That is a tough break for the Clan. SFU's only points coming off that 30-yard pass to Rice and John on the last play of the first half, and of course Simon Fraser getting a touchdown taken off the board for a celebration in the first half of play. Parlay that with two pick sixes in the second half, and the Simon Fraser Clan in a pickle here. Smith with a lob, and looking for the tight end, can't make that one happen.
No good.
But the damage done at 26-7, that's a 19-point lead with 5:17 remaining. And things looking good for the Hard Rockers right now.
And now for here for Simon Fraser again, you got to, the offense just got to pick yourself back up again. We've had a couple unfortunate plays. You mentioned the Cobb penalty, wiping the score off the board, and then the two pick sixes here has been a large part of the difference here. But now you've got 5 minutes left in this game. Lots of time left to run your offense and see what you've got.
And if you're them, I know it sounds like a cliche, but boy, you gotta get whatever positives you can out of every situation.
Yeah, just try some different things in the playbook and see what works. And you know, it's a long season. We're only here in week three, and this is a very young team. You've got a lot of guys that are playing, you know, their first home game here in Vancouver in beautiful British Columbia, and you know, a lot of learning experiences tonight. And hopefully, they can take this with them as they move on to face Azusa Pacific next week.
And we'll be here for that broadcast on Clan TV as well. Hope you can join us. We'll see the Clan getting into their GNAC schedule. As we mentioned off the top, Azusa Pacific this coming Saturday and then four straight on the road, followed by the final two games at home. Nice return being made by the Clan here as they get up close to the 30-yard line.
And just a note on the Azusa Pacific, just checking the score here. They trail Western Oregon 34-16 with about 7 minutes left in the third quarter. So GNAC football in full swing starting next week for Simon Fraser. Of course, only four teams now in the conference with Humboldt making their way out this past offseason. So,
and we talked about that Lone Star Conference, and the competition they're going to give teams from the GNAC is going to be spectacular.
It's going to be really good. And, you know, you talked with Coach Ford earlier in the week about just that experience of playing football in Texas, and just the talent level and just the competition level down there is next level. And I think it's great for Simon Fraser to be able to compete in a conference that they're going to see some of the best players in Division II football.
Well, it's all adding up to pushing the program forward, but, boy, these are painful steps.
After the play, there was a unsportsmanlike conduct again. That's got to be six or seven unsportsmanlike conduct penalties, Howie, for, I guess, two teams. They did play last season as well, a bit more of a one-sided affair than this one was, but some bad blood, it seems.
Hey, non-conference, but you couldn't tell by the way these two teams have gone at it. Here's Nixich stepping up in the pocket, has a man, and that's going to be a first down, a pass to Solomon Hines, who's going to take a tough lick at the end of that play, but not before he gains about 15 yards.
And that's what I like. I like seeing Hines out of the backfield a bit more, getting him in space, break a tackle, show off that speed, and get a first down.
So the Clan move the chains, and although the clock says only 4:50 remaining in what looks like a pretty dire situation here right now, they will continue to plug away. First and 10 at the 44-yard line of the Hard Rockers.
Well,
Kircher puts some air under it, has a man and a completion. And a nice job there for another first down.
That's a great throw.
Ryan Naylor making the catch. So Naylor and Riley Morrison do a nice job joining that pass-catching group along with Ethan Basalt and Ryson John today. Kester Owunzi as well. We haven't seen Robert Metters, who scored the lone touchdown last week, number 15. Gavin Cobb in motion.
Oh, he's got
Cobb sits down. Oh, and he's going to come back against the grain. Can he make some magic happen? Stutter step move, and Gavin Cobb.
It's coming back, though. A block in the back, Howie. Boy, on the front side of that play, he had number six, Morrison, in the corner of the end zone, if he would have seen him. But on that rollout play, went back to Cobb. Friendly face here tonight. But Nixitch just didn't quite look as downfield as they needed to. Had a man open in the end zone. But I think this one's coming back anyway. It's like a block in the back. Be a spot foul.
So we'll see where they mark it here. It'll stay first down. It's going to be first in about...
maybe 16, 17, yeah. Be a spot foul there, so Cobb will get the reception, but 10 yards from the spot there where it was done.
So see if the Clan can get themselves back on the straight and narrow here on this play. Nixit scrambling, but he's going to go down, and that's going to be a sack. And number 38, Thomas Chapman, who's been all over the place defensively, I think will get credit for that one.
Yeah, just not much time there for Nixitch to sit and step up. SFU had some really long developing routes downfield. If he would have had a bit more time, I think he had somebody downfield, but fortunately did not have the time and takes the sack.
Looks like about second and, I don't know what you want to call that now, second and 21. It's a big, big play here now for the Clan. They'd love to get a huge chunk back. Here's Nixitch. Steps up in the pocket. Gets turned around, reverses his field, keeps his eyes downfield and slings it. Oh, and Ryson John is being mugged, but it's a touchdown! Ryson John with a touchdown. He battled his defender.
There's a flag, though, Howie. We'll see who it's on. I thought it was defensive pass interference, but Ryson did kind of tug him as well. I'd love to see a replay here.
Wow, that looked like a physical battle royal there. Nixitch, like a pinball machine, though, keeps his eyes downfield and just releases.
Yeah,
well, we didn't get a good look at it there, but it looks like it's going to go against the Clan.
Yeah, offensive pass interference, I think, against John.
Night.
Yeah, couldn't quite tell from up here.
We couldn't tell, yeah.
It was a battle for sure. I couldn't quite tell who initiated contact and who was tugging who, but... referees do call it against Simon Fraser and really marching them back.
Sure would like to see that again. And not this part of the play, but the end part of the play.
Yeah, we're not
going to quite see it. That's a shame.
Yeah, you see the Hard Rock defender falling down and John catching the ball, but tough break there.
A strong 6'7" receiver normally is going to have the built-in advantage. Here's Nixitch running to the sideline, making a pass, and it is complete.
Another flag in the backfield, though, Howie. I think this one's coming back, too.
Wow. So the Clan trying to get some traction here, just can't get it done. Solomon Hines again, though, showing some nice hands out of the backfield.
I like him out of the backfield, catching the ball in space, showing off that speed.
Wow. Well, unable to get a real clear look at the Ryson John touchdown.
Another penalty against Simon Fraser, marching them 10 yards further back.
Have you ever seen a longer, oh my God, what is that?
It's got to be about second and 40. Yeah, second and 45.
Second and 45, they say, wow.
That's a bit to go. Right? Consecutive penalties on consecutive plays. Really pushing Simon Fraser back into their own end.
So the Clan staring at second and forever here as Nikšić looks downfield. Instead, he'll just throw it away on second down.
Not many plays in the playbook for second and 45, Holly, so.
There aren't? In a game where two pick six touchdowns in the second half, as well as two Clan touchdowns being taken off the board. That's a big swing.
Yeah, big plays, big moments tonight. But just not in favor of Simon Fraser. Timeout here for the Hardrockers.
I guess, Nick, if you're not learning from it, it's not productive time here. But I think Brandon Nikšić is learning as we go. It might be painful in moments for him, but...
Yeah, he's going to need an ice bath, too. We'll give the defense an ice bath and then
then let the
Nikšić
offense have
as
one.
Well.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's been running around a couple times here tonight. But Simon Fraser doing what they can. And, you know, just a couple breaks didn't go their way. It hasn't been, you know, an overwhelmingly one-sided affair as maybe the score would indicate. I mean, it's a three-score game. It's not that bad. But yeah, just a couple moments, couple plays here and there, and a couple penalties. Just hasn't gone Simon Fraser's way, and looks like they're going to be on the short end of the stick tonight.
Well, the defense stepped up big, and I think if they go into their meetings this week, they really have something to hang their hat on defensively, putting them in some real tough situations and responding against this Hardrockers team.
You know what? I think this is good for Nikšić, though. Second full game here in his young collegiate career, you know, a freshman, and getting some tape. Getting to see what see what he missed, see what he made, kind of thing. And so, you know, there's definitely some positives that you can take from tonight. It's just disappointing that the score really doesn't indicate the true, the true score that it could have been tonight. Those two pick sixes really, really digging deep into Simon Fraser's heart.
This time, going deep down the field to Rice and John.
He's got a cannon, though. Hey, look
at
that ball.
He does. He can really sling it, and he. It's a little too much on this one. That might be the reaction you have to just put a little extra on it after what happened in the battle for that possession.
It's been a frustrating night, you know. He's a young quarterback, and obviously, you know, everybody plays to win. And so when you've had a couple rough breaks and, you know, you're running around a bit back there, it's been a tough night.
26-7, 2:18 remaining. Metzler now punting the ball away. It's going to take a nice Clan bounce. It's going to go down at about the 10-yard line. So that Simon Fraser defense, especially on third down, has been impressive tonight. Just in jeopardy too many times, too many situations.
Yeah, just some short fields and you know, they made some plays. That great interception on the sideline here and then the big run by Hines. Really thought Simon Fraser was turning a corner there, but fortunately some things didn't go their way.
So only the clock left between the South Dakota victory here with 2:01 remaining. We get to 2 minutes in counting.
Ford's going to use his first timeout tonight. He's got two remaining. Used one and try and get Nikšić the ball back to have a late score here.
We talked about off the top, Nick, everybody in the GNAC entered play tonight with an 0-2 record. If Azusa Pacific doesn't come back against Western Oregon, you'll have two pretty desperate teams here a week from today right here at Swangard Stadium.
Yeah, and I'm interested to see what Azusa Pacific brings. I mean, they're the reigning GNAC champions from last year. They went to the Division II playoffs, lost to Tarleton State, as we mentioned earlier. The Tarleton State was the winner of the Lone Star Conference. SFU played Angelo State last week with the loss. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what Azusa Pacific has caught up, and, you know, Western Oregon giving them a tough time in their own barn. So, we'll see what next week brings.
Well, that Lone Star Conference is something else. Here's a short little pass. The Hardrockers make it. It'll stop the clock at 1:52. The starting quarterback for Angelo State last week was Patrick Mahomes' backup for one season at Texas Tech. I mean, that is crazy.
That's a good football player right there for sure.
Yeah. Just shows you the pedigree of players that are around there in the state of Texas.
Yeah, the talent level in Texas.
Wow.
It's next level, and they just support so many teams too. It's pretty awesome.
Brendan Lowry trying to jump the route there and take a quick path to the end zone. Almost pulled it off, it looked like.
And do give him the first down, and that should be enough to run the clock out here, Howie.
Simon Fraser will take another timeout here. Well, you know what? Young players being put in tough situations earlier in their career really...
Yeah. We talked about
something
earlier,
to build on,
I think
yeah.
it was eight freshman starters here tonight. Mm-hmm. And, you know, as the season progresses, they're going to learn from their mistakes and learn from, you know, what tape Coach Ford and Coach Summers and Coach Holland are going to show them. And you got to learn, and it's steps on a ladder, right? You're starting at the bottom here. Simon Fraser's had a pretty rough go over these past few years, a couple winless seasons. And, you know, to be down to a legitimate Division II program, just three scores here early on in the season is you know, there's no moral victories. I don't believe in moral victories, but it's a good game for Simon Fraser. Defensively showed a lot of heart and really dug their heels in at key times in the game and stopped the South Dakota team when they needed to. Unfortunately, offensively, just couldn't get the ball rolling.
Two touchdowns came off the board. I look at that and I just go.
Two touchdowns off the board and two defensive
pick sixes.
So it was a game of big swings there.
Well, that's a 28-point turnaround right there. So, yeah, tough night. And really would have liked to have seen that Rice and John contact with the defensive back there in the corner deep in the end zone or towards the end zone. Couldn't quite get a good look at that one. Down to under a minute remaining here. And if you're South Dakota, you're certainly liking what you're seeing from your redshirt sophomore starting quarterback.
Again, Smith looked pretty good tonight. He made some throws when he needed to. They didn't lean on him a ton. You know, just the one interception on the amazing sideline play, but you know, took a couple sacks, but didn't make any huge mistakes and let their defense win that game for them, and their run game as well were really good. I bet you they have over 200 yards on the ground here tonight.
Well, kudos to their team for filling in big holes. We talked about this. Jake Sullivan, their graduating quarterback, held 17 school records and graduated. Connor Silveria, their running back, rushed for 452 yards in one game, an all-time D2 single-game record last season. And Isaiah Manley was a guy who had 91 catches for their team. Yep. So, you know what? They
it's
had
a lot to replace.
Losses
it's a
too.
Lot
yeah.
to replace, yeah. And you see some positive signs with Smith and Zur and Ahmad Lewis in the backfield and Roth coming in as well. So, a good team here and a good victory for the Hardrockers. Never, you know, coming a long way from South Dakota up to Vancouver, and it's been a while since they've been here, but it was a good win coming in here on a Saturday night to come in and play hard.
It's certainly great to chat with the South Dakota crew in for the game. Football, a universal language, and so fun to talk about past battles between these two teams. Well, 43 seconds left in this game.
Probably just one more play. And that'll be about it here, Howie.
So Simon Fraser is going to have to retrench and get ready for Azusa Pacific as the GNAC schedule starts for real this coming Saturday right here at Swangard Stadium. You can join us again on Clan TV for that contest.
Yeah, and all in all, some positives, some negatives here for Simon Fraser, but with such a young team, you got to learn, and you're going to get, as long as you don't get outworked, out-hustled, and you know, as long as that tape still looks good, there's ways to learn and build and grow, and I think that's what this season's going to be.
And that will do it. That is what we hope will transpire following this game. A tough game for Simon Fraser. They come away with a 26-7 loss. Still searching for that elusive win to snap the D2 losing streak. But some positives to build on. I know that might sound tired after a while, but this young Simon Fraser team, I think, revealed some things to itself about what it has. And it will be great to see what Gavin Cobb does as he gets more accustomed to. This is his first game under head coach Thomas Ford.
Totally. Like, an added element, and had over 100 yards receiving, looked really good. Some short passes, some long passes. And, this Simon Fraser offense clearly has some things to work on, but showed really some moments of brilliance, and I think there's definitely some things to build on.
Yeah, Gavin Cobb almost 200 yards all-purpose here, and the quarterback as well, Brandon Nixitch, getting more of an indoctrination here to NCAA Division II football. So we will, I think, call it a wrap for tonight. Our next home game, September the 28th, 6 p.m. Saturday. Join us right here at Swangard Stadium via Clan TV. If you can't make it down, for everyone on our crew, thank you for all your efforts today. And we will be back with you again next week. For Nick Sirski, I'm Howard Samura. Safe travels, and we'll see you all again right here at Swangard Stadium 1 week from today.